morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to day two. I repeat, day two. It's a much warmer day here in Amanzimtoti, and day two's program will start masters, and this category is men 35 to 49 years old, followed by the women masters, also category 35 to 49 years old. The men will run 8 kilometers, and like I said already, we can see that the wind is not blowing, the sun is shining, it is not so cold, so we are going to have a great day. I will bring Temo Madima just to greet you guys good morning in a little bit, and I'm sure he will agree with you guys that today's weather is much, much, much better. Today's weather is much better. And this will be good for competition. I do hope that the weather does stay like this, because as we move along the program, get some exciting runs off the way. The program will go masters, men and women. This is age 35 to 49. Followed by the junior women and junior men. The junior woman will run 6 kilometers. The junior men will run 8 kilometers. The senior woman will run 10 kilometers. The senior men will run 10 kilometers. Followed by the girls 14 years old and the boys 14 years old, which will, they will run 44 kilometers. So we are getting ready for the start of the men. Then, as I was saying with the program, after the boys and girls 15 years old, we go to the girls and boys 16 years old. The girls will run 40 kilometers and the boys will run 60 kilometers. And I have Temo Madima here now.
A very good morning to everybody. I hope everybody's doing well. We are ready and geared up for day number two. We're gonna have a very fun time, a good time. The weather today is much better. Kurt, yesterday you were shivering, today you are smithering. Is that even a word? It sounded good and it rhymes, and I hope it's gonna be a great one. The men, the 35 to 49, 8 kilometers, that's about to kick off now. That's where it's gonna take place. Again, we're gonna get to that exciting hill. This is where a lot of that can happen. But we're gonna get started. Here we go for the men, 4 kilometers.
The men 4 kilometer is about to start. Let's all keep our eyes to the start. Today I also got name lists of some of these men, and with the name list I'll be able to give you guys more or less the information of who's on the lead and what province.
This gate is not going to work today. It's only 1 kilometer. It's only 2 kilometers. Don't have 1 kilometer.
Yeah, don't have 1 kilometer.
And ladies, you'll be going at 10 minutes past 8 in about 49 minutes time. 39 minutes.
go to Rafa City. Go to Rafa City. Yananke. Yananke, to reboot. Zana go kick him on tour.
We need the managers from Athletics Free State.
Timber, I need to know. Am I lying?
Managers from Free State Athletics, you need to come and report here to the results people at the finish line to sort out some disputes. Managers from Athletics Free State, you need to make your way out to the finish line. Come see the results people. They have some queries to sort out with you.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the hospital. Roger guys, one lap completed, 6 minutes 50 seconds for you for your first 2Ks. 6 minutes 50 seconds for you guys, lap number 2, you've got 3 more laps to go. Go Eric and Jonathan, boys is Sipo. Let's go to the boys from Kwazulu Natal. 7 minutes 10 seconds for you guys coming through here now for your first 2Ks. You've got 3 more laps, guys. Running time now, guys. 7 minutes 28 seconds for you as you start your second lap. Seconds for you guys as you start your second lap down. Right guys, second lap for you. 4 minutes okay, you're running it at the moment. Exactly 8 minutes here for you guys as you start your second lap. 3 more to go. 8 minutes 10 seconds running time at the moment.
My life now. Thank you.
Mola Master Woman. We'd like you to come here now onto this field and now please Mola Master Woman. It's a woman at 35 to 49, Master Woman. You need to make your way now onto the stock field and now where the Orange Men's Athletic Club tents are. So the woman on the far side of the field there, where the corn area is, you need to come up here now, please. All the Master Woman running the second race, we need you up here now, please.
Come on, my life now.
Right, here comes the Master Men completing the second lap, starting the third lap here now. Guys, your running time is 13 minutes 40 seconds. We are starting your third lap here now. 4Ks to go, guys. And you got a big lead bunch here. Jonathan Edwards up there from KwaZulu-Natal. So, well done, guys. Well done, guys. 13 minutes and 58 seconds. Eric and Gubana there from the top. Well done, boys. Well done. It's your third lap here now, guys. 4Ks to go. Another call, please, for all the Master Woman, please, 35 to 49. We need you up there now onto the top field there, where the Orange Men's Athletic Club tents are. We need you up here now, please, all the Master Woman. Minutes 40 seconds for these men. Sipo Mbongo going through there now from KZNA. Lap number 3 here, guys, as you finish your second lap, you've got 4Ks to go. Exactly 15 minutes and 4 seconds for you. You guys starting your third lap here. You guys coming through here now, you're starting your third lap, your running time 60 minutes for you guys, you're running at 4 minutes okay. Lap number 3, guys, you've got 4Ks to go. For you guys, two more laps to go. Lap number 3. I feel safe, isn't it? Hey. Last call for all the master women, 35 to 49. You need to come up here onto the top field so we can start assembling you ladies in your provincial teams. All the master ladies up onto the top field, please.
Come on, in my life.
We need to get you into your provincial teams. All the master women, yeah, you'll be running 4 kilometers, so that means you'll be running 2 laps here this morning.
If you come out to Divi, you can't go out to Kwamba. I feel like you will take your own Kwamba shit. Just quiet. Yeah? That's what the life now.
Master Woman, you've got exactly 20 minutes to go to the start of your race. Master Woman, 20 minutes to go. Starting his final lap here, 20 minutes and 20 seconds for the leaders here now. Well done, guys. Last lap, 2Ks to go. And the field starting to spread out here now. So well done there, guys. 20 minutes and 35 seconds for you. Last lap here, guys, 2Ks to go. Jonathan Edwards from Natal, having a good run here this morning. 20 minutes 46 seconds. Go, Jonathan. Right, guys, last lap here for you. It's the master men, yeah? 20 minutes and, 21 minutes now. 21 minutes now for you guys. Starting your last lap here. Eric and Kubani having a good run here as well. Well done, Eric. 21 minutes for you, 21 minutes 15 seconds, 2 kilometers to go, last lap, guys. Thank you. 2 days to go.
And the paramedics are taking care of him, so this is really, really good. This is really, really good. The back of the pack also still making their way in, and I will take us to where some of these men will get lapped, some of these men will get lapped as we take action onto the guys coming down the hill, the guys coming in as well. Guys are coming in. I will go to the uphill where the leaders are going to be coming. I do believe the leaders are going to lap these guys. We just have to keep our eyes focused on these guys. Good morning, guys. Welcome to Amanzimtoti. We're bringing you action from the men's masters, men age 35 to 49. The leaders are from CGA. CGA is in the lead here. So we have to keep our eyes glued for CGA. You can see the guys also coming for their third lap. Guys coming for their third lap and completing it. And we have a shot here of towards the end of the pack. This man is still coming in four. Must come and complete. He's going to finish his third lap. So our eyes are there on the third, on the third lap. So we are bringing you action. We can see the guys coming in. You can see the guys coming in. There is our leader coming down the hill. Our leader coming down the hill.
As you can see, they're working their way up the hill at the moment now. Men from CGA still in the lead. So they're the ones that are currently taking the pace out hard, and they're pushing it on, and it looks good at the moment. Phenomenal running from these two gentlemen.
While the others are going up the hill, some of them are still falling from behind. Tough course, but it's very exciting to see everybody running now. We are soon expecting the leaders to come to the finish, as they've been leading for quite a while.
Winner here this morning, got to 8 categories here, so he is definitely winning his 8 category. And
there you have it, the first athlete to cross the finish line. This is our winner today.
Mbongeni from Central Gauteng Athletics. Well done, Mbongeni. Very, very good winner here this morning. Well done, well done.
The first winner of today's event is Mr. Mbongeni Nazozo, 1356.
Omar Kumwane, Omar Omar, yeah, very good run here. And also to Kole Chuane from Central Gauteng Athletic. Well done, Kala.
The second athlete to finish is Mr. Mweletsi Muletsane. And then after him came
Motsumai Motone. Well done, well done, Motsumai. Well done, guys. Well done. Good running, guys. 27 minutes, 42 seconds.
While they're finishing, others are still traveling behind, going up the hill, and more people are crossing the finish line as
well. Good run here this morning. Well done, guys. Well done. Yes, the finish line here. Let's run hard to the line here, guys. Well done, guys. 28 minutes and 5 seconds
guys,
for you for your 8K.
Guys,
good
sorry.
Running here. Well done. Me?
I am back. Kurt is back. As we got. We're getting the men coming in for the finishing of here. You can see that it's, the sun is shining today. 8 kilometers. I do believe from my colleague over here that the winner ran in the region of high 27. And I was just checking, it was the gentleman from CGA that won the race. CGA 1 and 2. So they are strong. But we, as we are, shift our focus from the leaders. We see that some of the guys are coming in. They're making their way for those for that final 1 kilometer, that final 800 meters, that final 800 meters. And with that, we will show you some more footage of guys coming in. You can see that they are tired. The course is brutal. It's not easy. They are trying, and then as we are trying, we're going to see here a gentleman that is going to make his way for the finish as he's going for his final loop. We see the guys that are these guys here that we've just shown you. They've already gone past halfway or almost done finishing. So as we go there, we show you some more footage of the guys coming in. These are the guys that are really at the bottom of the pack. We can see that they are really spread out. We see one or two runners now making their way finishing. So it is not easy. And once again, you can see runners coming in. Athletics South Africa adhering to the COVID-19 protocol. Runners are done. They are sanitizing. So the men, 35, are almost done. And as the men, 35, are almost done, we are going to start shifting our focus to the woman, 35 to 49 years old. And as we do that, we can see the men coming in. The men coming in. They are the women preparing to start. As the women are preparing to start, we will give you feed on the men finishing their 8 kilometer. This is grueling. It is not easy. And the men are nearing the end. And as they near the end, we are getting ready to welcome the woman. We can see the men finishing. As the men are finishing, the woman will be getting ready. The men, I do believe, not too long to go now, and they will be done. So we are here to bring you all the action. I do believe, like yesterday, there's only 1 clock, so we will be setting every single start. We will be bringing every single start for you guys. The guys are nearing the end. They're on the grueling part of the course over here, where they go down the hill and they make their way up. So keep your eyes open.
Gideon Zumbeni from Gauteng, Athletics Gauteng, North London, hey, Gideon.
So men are going down. Men are going down. So our cameras are there. We have the men. We have the men coming in. It is difficult. It is not easy. And then we can see that the guys are cleaning the course, getting ready for the women. And as the women are getting ready, the final runners are making their way here. They are making their way. That's the most grueling part of the track, is as they make their way down. I do believe four 500 meters from the start, it is the grueling part of the track. They make their way down, they make their way up the hill, and we are ready to bring you all the action. The men are tired. 8 kilometers is not easy. They are coming in. Athletics in Mpumalanga, Athletics Limpopo, all the runners are here in this Masters category. Limpopo Athletics is there, AGN over there. So the men are coming in. I do believe that this might be the last runner here of the men. This gentleman is at the bottom of the pack. I do believe that this runner would number 978 is the last runner. He's from Athletics South Western District, Gavin, Mr. Gavin Yanchis. Congratulations to Mr. Gavin Yanchis, as he is finishing this. He is determined to finish this race. As he is finishing this race, we go and we can see how the men are tired. This is not easy. Not easy at all. Not easy at all. My commentary partner today is also a sprinter, so this young man has got some years on me. He's definitely faster than me, and he also shakes his head when he says, when I say 8 kilometers, he just shakes his head. I do apologize. Mr. Yankees is not at the end, but we can see a few more runners coming in. They are determined to finish. As they are coming in for the finish, the judges are making their final checks with the woman. The Masters category is a very large category, so they are checking all the bib numbers, making sure the runners are here. It is a very, very big group, and with this group, everything needs to be on point. The men making their way to the end, where they will go up the hill. They will loop around, and we will focus on them finishing. So the two tricky parts of the track are when they come down the feed that we have now. They go up a hill, it's relatively flat, and then as they go past the whiteboard, it is a very, very steep downhill. It is then they go into quite a wet part of the track, when they make their way onto the finish line. So I do believe we might have a few more runners coming up here. We might have a few more runners coming up here. The men are determined. They are determined to finish. They are determined to finish. It is not easy. We can see there at the distance, they are nearing the end. As we can see that, we will try and bring you in where these guys will be coming in. They will be finishing. So let's keep our eyes on that finish, as as we try and see the women are getting ready, and as we can see the final men are coming in to the finish. 37 minutes for this gentleman, and we will get the heads up on the start of the women's race. But as we see the men coming in, you can see the judges doing their final checks, the teams bunched up together, the different provinces probably planning their race plan. I'm sure they do have the different runners. So I see the clock is, the clock is reset, so I'm sure we are going to be getting ready to watch the woman start. We have our eyes peeled on the woman. The judges are doing their final check. The clock is set. The woman will only run 4 kilometers. Masters woman, same category, 35 to 49 years old. We are represented here by all the provinces. We have Athletics Central Northwest, we have Free State, we have AGN, we have Athletics in Mpumalanga, we have Athletics Northwest, we have Athletics Vaal Triangle, we have Border Athletics, we have CGA in their numbers, we have Eastern Province Athletics only by one runner, we have KwaZulu-Natal, we have KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, we have Limpopo Athletics, we have Western Province Athletics. So the category for the woman masters 35 to 49 has 39 contestants. This is going to be a good race. You can see the women are getting ready to start. The judges are walking, having their final check. We can see the judge there probably going to the provinces and making sure, oh, he has left the field. So we are going to get ready for the start of the women's masters 4 kilometer race. I have my finger on the timer, guys. We will get you guys on the time. We will get this exciting start. It's always exciting to see the starters. They start frantically fast, trying to gain position. So keep your eyes open for the start of this woman masters category. As the women masters category is coming up, I do see that Mr. Ntomi from Athletics in Mpumalanga is making his way to the finish. Congratulations to this man. Just I hope I don't miss it, but I'll give you a quick feed. Oh, I've lost him. But Mr. Ntomi is making his way. And here we have the women masters starting. The space is fast. They will they will juggle for position. And we have them underway. I didn't forget to start. We have the timer down. Masters woman 35 to 49. They will be running 4 kilometers. 4 kilometers is 2 loops of the track. 4 kilometers is two loops of the track. So keep your eyes open for these women. I see AGN in the lead, followed by Northwest over there. So this is going to be a great race. 39 women in this category. This is going to be one hell of a race. Another big entry, just like the men. So this will be good. We will bring you all the action. Once again, they are running 4 kilometers. They will loop twice. We will have the action for you as we see the woman making their way. We see Mr. Sitome coming in for his finish. We have to congratulate this man from Athletics in Mpumalanga. He will finish the race, and the women are going down the hill into the lush jungle of this Amazontoti course that we have here for the SA Cross Country Championships 2021. In day one, we managed to have the younger generation, the future of athletics in South Africa. And with this today, we also have quite a lot of categories, and it's also nice to have the Masters running. And as we getting ready to get the Masters coming up the hill, we see that everyone is ready. Slight breeze blowing, nothing compared to yesterday. And once the women make their way to this up here, we will bring it up. They will, like I said, this is the tricky part. They go down, they come up. This is the longest uphill section of the course. They will come up where they will go around the whiteboard, down a very, very, very steep downhill onto the wet part of the course, where they will then loop. And with that loop, they will then be making their way onto the finish line. You can see today's weather is a whole lot better. We see a young man there, shorts and a t-shirt. You can see the people around him as well, not so much in jackets and in beanies. You can see everyone is comfortable. Today is not so cold. We can see also footage of the officials getting ready to show the way for the Masters women as they make their way onto the course. They will be coming up this hill. As we can see the judges pointing out a few things of the course where they will loop and come up here. The judges are making sure that everything is running smoothly. We will see again slight wind, nothing too hectic like yesterday. People in t-shirts, in shorts, people not wearing beanies. This time around they're wearing sunglasses because the sun is actually shining, and the sun actually makes a very, very, very big difference. And as I say this, I will switch back just so that we can get a feed and not miss anything on the woman coming in. We can see water stands, the judges speaking to one another, making sure everything is ready, making sure everything is on point so that we have no hiccups. If I can say, the women have started to come up the hill. They will be making their way more or less halfway. This is more or less halfway point. We see AGN here in the lead. We have 510 Leilani from AGN, followed by 514 Catherine, also from AGN. These ladies are in the lead, followed by 157 Minette Bell from ACN Athletics Central Northwest. This is the lead group at the moment. I will try to give you more or less the top four. We have 1248 in fourth place over there. 1248 is from CGA, Ilza Marais, coming in for their first loop. We can see them coming in. I can hear the people cheering them on. The people are watching from a distance, and we can see them battle it out. They are battling it out for the lead. As the lead pack goes to conclude this first lap, we can see some of the runners middle pack towards the end of the pack making their way down the hill. As they make their way down the hill, they will go up, and they will go up here, and then they make their way around the board. And the lead pack now makes its way down the steep part of the track, around the whiteboard. Like I said, they go around the whiteboard, down the steep part of the track, and as they make their way down that, it's very, very short until they do their first 2 kilometers. Middle of the pack over there coming in to conclude their lap. We can see now this is really towards the end of the group. They're making their way past, this is now past the lush jungle, up the uphill onto a quite a very steep part, around the whiteboard, down a steep uphill onto the wet part of the track. And as these runners are making their way to complete the loop, we are going to be getting the women that are in the lead, the Masters women that are in the lead, coming to us right now to complete their loop. So yet again we have, I see they are pulling a distance, AGN is pulling a distance, AGN led here by Miss Lelani Sheffer, followed by Mr. Catherine Skosana. They are the 1 and 2. After that then is CGA number 1248, Ilza Marais. So these women are battling it out for the lead. We can see now they are literally together, quite for some action over here. Action over here as we bring the rest of the runners. And while the rest of the runners are coming in, we can see this contest here by the AGN woman. This is their final lap. So this is where they will be finishing, followed by CGA 1248. 1248, if my memory serves me right, is Miss Ilza Marais. And as we see these women coming in, we see the ones going to conclude their lap. As they are there concluding their lap, they are on their last lap. They are on their last lap. This is a tough course. It is not an easy course. With this, I respect these women. 4 kilometers is not easy. Masters 35-249. I would probably assume that the leaders might be the younger woman, and they are really, really, really doing well. These ladies will definitely, without a doubt, beat me in 4 kilometers. Like I said yesterday, 4:01 is 1 meter too long for me. I guess I will be in trouble. And then we will switch feed just to see the end as well. See those girls coming in, the middle and the end of the group, as we can see them coming in. And as we see them coming in, we do see the middle of the pack making their way almost to halfway. And I would like to welcome Temba as he has something to say.
A very good morning to everybody who is watching. It's been a good day. I hope Kurt has been taking care of you. We are currently running the 4 kilometer cross-country masters women 35-249. That race kicked off at 8:10, and it's a swift program. Everything runs according to time and schedule. Believe it or not, cross-country is super organized, and it's always good to watch, Kurt, because you know how it is. As soon as one race starts, it just kicks off to the next. There's literally no time for mistakes, no time to breathe.
Temba, I have to agree with you, because the organization for this event has been so far so good. The judges are making their final checks. Everything is on time. If we are late, I mean, two minutes is nothing, Temba. This is really, really nothing. They are on time. They start us on time. If there's someone that's at fault, it'll probably be me that I forget to start the clock. I get so excited with the start of the women's race that I get excited and I lose track to get that start going. But I will try not to make that mistake today. And as we see these women making their way down for their final lap, we see the woman coming in to start their final lap. This is not an easy track.
Masters woman
underway. This is going to be really, really interesting. Temba,
absolutely, absolutely, Kurt. I agree with you. The course is very tough. For those who have been watching from day one, the track is actually quite challenging. Some tough hills. There's a lot of different places where there's some wet areas, there's some hills, there's downhills. It's a beautiful track. Ladies and gentlemen, it is day number two. The weather is phenomenal. Compared to yesterday, it feels a bit like heaven. We were shivering here in the commentator's booth yesterday. But today, you know, the clubs are out. It's always good to see all these athletes smiling. There aren't many spectators, but I hope everybody who's watching online is able to feast themselves on one of the world's, I say it and believe me, one of the world's toughest race on 2 feet. Cross country is a race like no other. Brilliant for middle distance running and long distance running for preparation for those. But it's cross country is a world in its own, where there's a lot of competitions. As you can see, currently the lady who is in the lead from AGN, Lialani Sheffer, currently just pushing the pace, and with her she's got Catherine Skosana. Now obviously that's a well-known name in the cross-country road running and athletics in South Africa. She's also just latching on to her, and you can see these two ladies from AGN are making sure that they're gonna make this pace a good one. They're gonna break off everybody else, and they want to bring back that first and second place, so you can look out for more action there. That's a beautiful shot from the back there, where there's the uphill as well as the downhill. And as they turn here, you'll see they will come up to the uphill, and we'll catch the picture for you there as they come through for what is the latter part, actually the more easier part of the lap. And from there on, it's a bit more downhill. So if you're watching with us, you know, comment, send us a message. If you're watching on YouTube, this is the Athletic South Africa. This is the Athletic South Africa Cross Country Championships. And as more ladies are trickling in, as you can see there, it is a tough course. I've said it once and I'll say it again. I don't know if it was even tougher yesterday with the wind as well as the super cold conditions. But then again, we spoke to President of ASA, Mr. James Muloi. He said it's actually quite better when it's cold. When he remembers his running days, running at international European meets, he says it's super cold. It's freezing. What happened yesterday was not that bad. So I guess he's tough, but he's also been there. But it is true, cross country usually takes place in the winter seasons in Europe or abroad in America as well, compared to us in South Africa, where we have it in our championships in spring and more towards early months of summer. Now that is just because of the way our season is. We operate on an international season, but we have to also respect our local season. So that's a bit challenging, especially for athletes that will be looking to qualify for the World Cross Country Championships that are coming up. We've also got a jam-packed year. There's Cross Country Championships coming up. There's World Championships. There's Commonwealth Games. There's competitions. Do not stop next year. So it's just one of those challenges. As you can see there, just a bit of transmitter challenges. As we said as well earlier, it's very difficult for us to get a motorbike on this track. The way it is built, it's literally built 4 feet only, and it makes it super challenging for the bikes to get in there. But we are trying to give you the best as we can. I know you guys would love to see the race, every single inch of the race, but here we are. Here is your winner, all the way from AGN, and she is followed by another athlete from AGN, and that duo currently is of Lialani Sheffer as well as Catherine Skosana. And in third place, let's see which athlete will be coming in from third place. It looks like it's the athlete from CGA. She goes by the name of Ilza Murray. Kurt just whispered her or shouted her name in my ear. He's been studying these names the whole weekend, and it's exciting to see. And obviously the athlete coming in over there from it's NW?
number 862. Number 862. I do believe it's from a
Athletics
Northwest. Northwest North.
That is correct.
Gisella van der Berg.
Yes.
Gisella coming there, making the top spots for this race. As we see these women coming into the race, finishing the race, we will be able to now also be able to give you feed on the ones going down the hill. They're going down the hill to complete their race. And as we shift here, we can see that they now from here they make their way around the whiteboard down the hill to the wet part of this track. Quite the difficult part of the track. And I was noticing that the shoes of some of the men, Temba, they were really, really, really wet because of that part of the track. As they make their way to the finish, it's quite wet and it's quite thick. So women are coming in, they are finishing. Like you mentioned yesterday, Temba, it's not just about the gold medal. It's not just about the top three spots. It's also about participation. Yeah. So they have their own goals.
Absolutely. You know, the beautiful thing about cross-country, even just speaking to President James Moloi yesterday, is it is a mass participation sport. I mean, everybody who watched yesterday online would agree with me. That to see those young kids on the track, I mean, it was cold. It was a bit of a difficult one. You know, we're happy to see them on the track, but it was cold. But we saw a lot of smiles. We saw the parents online communicating. You know, the parents were cheering the names of their kids, writing their names, and just thanking ASA in general for making sure that this competition continues, because that's what we want. These kids worked so hard, Kurt, to make sure that they qualify for these championships. Already the teams had to be cut down due to COVID and the protocol of COVID, which we must respect, ladies and gentlemen. You know, but for each province to be able to send down less athletes, making it harder to even qualify for the championships. And then after doing so, you know, the fear of not being able to run, I think most of the parents, coaches were a bit distraught because of that. But fortunately, yesterday was 100% dedicated to the kids. They had their own full day, all the way from under 8 to under 13.
You are so right, Temba. And I must say, yesterday, despite the cold weather, Athletics South Africa brought this event. They got the mass participation that you are talking about. They got the athletes. They got the young boys, the young women, the future of South African athletics, ready to run and to race. I'm sure they did enjoy the moment. They ran their hearts out. Of course, they didn't do 4 kilometers. We only saw that the boys under 13 ran 4 kilometers yesterday. They looped twice, but the younger ones ran in the region of 2 to 3 kilometers, which is quite impressive for them. And we focus to the woman finishing. Just commentate.
While the women finish, we're looking forward to the next race, which will be the junior women 6 kilometer race.
As we get ready to witness the junior woman in the 60 kilometer, we will just be keeping you on the feed for the woman coming in, the masters woman coming in. And while some are coming in, others are still finishing the race. They are in the tricky part of the race, and this part is not a easy one at all. But as I give you footage over there, this woman finishing a race, congratulations to her. This is really, really, really well done. She will be making her way up the hill. And as she makes her way up the hill, we have a few athletes that will go around that white screen towards the finish line. And there we have some more runners coming. coming in, the judges bringing them in. As one comes in, we get ready to witness others finishing. 7:02. Let me get my name list out here. Temba usually laughs at me, but 7:02 is Izel Theron from Athletics in Mpumalanga. Izel Theron from Athletics in Mpumalanga making her way towards the finish line. As she makes her way towards the finish line, we see others coming in. Congratulations to these women, because this is really, really, really tough and not easy at all. The runners are coming in, they are tired. This track, this course, I wouldn't say track is a habit, you know. I do one lap, not two loops. I do a lap. So congratulations to these women as they are concluding this tough course. We see the COVID-19 protocols being adhered to. The weather is good, it is shining, you can see the flags are not blaring over there, the sun is shining, they're running with sunglasses. This is a much, much better day than yesterday. I do believe that no women are coming up from the jungle of the track, but rather we will focus on the women that have finished and they make their way to the water stations, perhaps get some Coca-Cola to bring their sugar levels back up. And while we see that, we will see that the judges have no one to check. Women are coming in there, 23 minutes. I also hear over here that they are calling the junior woman. They must get ready. This is the woman, 19 years old, junior woman category. They will be running 6 kilometers. I just heard that the junior women are going to be getting ready. They're getting ready to start this race. I believe the race will start at 9 o'clock. They will run 6 kilometers, and after the junior women, we're going to get the junior men, and they will run 8 kilometers. So we ready to see a 3-loop race and a 4-loop race, followed by the senior women and senior men, when they will go for the 10-kilometer cross-country race. And then we will also have the senior men and senior women that will contest in the 4 kilometers later on. That one will be action-packed. 2 loops, fast action. And as you see the clock winding down, we are getting ready to see some of the women running, and then we switch our views. As you can see, people relaxing, enjoying the weather. You can see also over there the junior woman. I'm guessing this will be their final call. This will be their final call. I do believe that there are no more women coming in. I just want to see if the clock has been stopped. I see this could be one of the women that is coming in towards the end of that pack. While she's making her way, the judges are getting the junior woman ready to go. As the junior woman are ready to go, we will be bringing you action of the junior woman. They will be running six kilometers, quite the distance for this race. So they are getting ready. As they are getting ready, we see how grueling this track is. It's not easy at all. It's a grueling, grueling race. She's been helped there, I presume, by a team manager. It is not easy. She's following the COVID-19 protocols once again. Thank you, Athletic South Africa, for bringing this cross-country championships 2021 to us here in Amanzimtoti. As the women are coming in, the girls are getting ready. The girls, 19 years old, are in the junior category. In this category, we have also quite a few contestants. Girls 19, 6 kilometers is also going to be contested by 39 young women. 39 young women. There will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 provinces represented for this junior women's race. My clock is there. See it, I will be ready to give you guys time as well. I do believe I have a lot of time. According to the program I have in front of me, this is going to start at 9 o'clock, and since I have quite some time, I'll just give you the provinces. You will have Athletic Central Northwest represented by four junior girls, Athletics Free State by 3, Alive Athletics Free State by 5 women, junior women. Athletics Gauteng North, known as AGN, by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 athletes. So this is a big group. You see them taking up their positions, getting there in the team, maybe discussing some tactics. So we were on 7 athletes by AGN. Next we have Athletics Mpumalanga, which will have 6 athletes, followed by Athletics Northwest North by 2 athletes, Athletics Transkei only 1 athlete. Central Gauteng Athletics, known as CGA, has got 6 athletes here. KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, the home favorites, they will be represented by 6 junior girls, and then to complete the lineup will be Western Province Athletics. So we have, like I said once again, 9 provinces in this category, all represented well. They will be doing a 6 kilometer, as I do believe. No, I'm wrong. I thought they would have also run maybe a shorter distance of 1 loop, but there's only 1 distance for the junior women and the junior men, and that will be 6 and 8 kilometers. Weather is much, much better here today. The wind is not blowing. Whenever I mention weather, my colleague here, he just laughs, because he got the luxury of arriving when the sun was shining. He didn't see me shivering, but he probably would have been laughing even more. I believe these young men are so cocky. You know, I guess it comes with that territory. He does 100 meters, and he just keeps laughing at me. It was really, really cold and windy. At least the clouds are shining. We do not have overcast. There is no wind or slight wind, if any wind at all. And as I say that, we can see all the girls busy getting ready. We can see the judges there in white walking. I do assume that they are getting the checklists ready. We see the girls doing their final warm-up routines. We see the AGN. We see 2 runners over there. 207, they're from Athletic Central Northwest. 207 and 188. Those are the girls from Athletic Central Northwest. Maybe they are teammates. I do not see the other two because they are represented by four girls. We don't see them, but I'm sure they are there. The one is there in the line waiting. So these girls running groups. Clearly this is, I'm sure there is an individual part to it, but I'm also sure that there is also a team element to cross country, if my mind is correct. They do run for the individual places, and then also there's also team places, so province places. So this is good. This is great. As we get ready for these girls to start, judges are making their final call. I see medics are getting ready in position. Weather's good, it's actually hot. I've taken off my jacket. I feel like I'm in the summer mood. So I'm happy. In this group of 9 provinces, 10 provinces, I beg your pardon, athletics, north, west, north, athletics, Transkei and Western Province Athletics are the smallest teams. The others have 4 or more athletes representing the province. You see the girls still there warming up, lifting their knees, having the final chats, stretching their quads. They are doing their final warm-up routines. Like I mentioned, they will start at 9 o'clock, and as they get ready, I will be keeping my eyes ready for the start. So let's just wait and let the time wind down as we wait for the girls. 6 kilometer cross country, girls 19, the junior woman, to start this race. We let the time wind down and I will be bringing you the action. Judges are making their final checks. As judges are making their final checks, you can see how the sun, it is sunny out there. This man did not bring his sunglasses. We do have a bit of the crowd, but they're only allowed to watch from a distance. I'm actually very, very fortunate from where I stand, being able to get this access to commentate and provide you the live stream via Back Sports, that I can watch some of this action way closer than some of the spectators can. But it's really, really nice to see there are a couple of spectators, parents of these young women, teammates that have already run. So we see them there, we see them walking across. As you can see, camera 3, slight wind, nothing at all. We see the bigger group of the girls. They are lining up, they are getting ready. The judges are getting these girls ready. As these girls are getting ready, I'm also getting ready to witness their start.
Yeah, you can also take me a picture. I think I deserve one. I bite again. Thanks, eh?
What are you doing? You're doing the TV, eh?
Yeah, the TV is live stream.
Okay. So you do your own thing and then they'll cut in on your channel and then they'll...
No, we have four cameras, they're all live. They just switch the channels.
Okay. So you gotta make sure you're doing your thing, you can't be focusing on the trees or...
Yeah, just focus on movement.
Sure, man.
As we're getting ready to watch these girls start, I called Temba over. He's been active with some of the close action, so he'll be able to bring you some more information on what's going on.
Absolutely, Kurt. The girls under 19 race is always exciting. These are the athletes that you want to look at. I mean, when you get to under 20 level, that's where it starts becoming serious. We've got a very phenomenal athletes in this one. I don't know about their form, you know, COVID has affected athletes so much in different ways, but if I look here, there's the likes of Kirsty Bell. She is, listen up, SA under 20 champion, as well as the SA, she's the SA steeplechase, sorry, I was a bit distracted by that camera. She's the SA steeplechase, 3000 steeplechase champion for senior. As well, in the same year, she did it as well for the juniors. I mean, that's phenomenal. Athlete at, to do that while she was a youth athlete at 17. So she's definitely a phenomenal athlete for the future. That was 2 years back already. And she's struggled with a bit of injuries, but she's fighting her way back. We've got a lot of other females that you can look out for. The likes of Sune Bass, Lionel Liber is in here as well. Linka, Asneiman, Tsulufelo, Dikoko. These are athletes from the Athletics Northwest. We've also got athletic free states such as Lushka Heymans, as well as Karabo Mavaso. You can look out for them. AGN, as I mentioned, Gabriella Gatesmith. This is an athlete that you want to look out for also. Very phenomenal runner. You can expect her to be part of the, as you can see, those are the AGN athletes are busy doing the strides. Kirsty Bell, as I mentioned, in there, as well as Isel Creer, as well as Chanel Creer in the mix as well there. Mpumalanga is also well represented with Danae Aramsa, as well as Lucky Mashilo. Those are athletes you can look out for. Zanel Sihohle, I think that is the sister of Folavio Sihohle. So you can definitely look out for her to be doing some phenomenal running on this one. She's more of a track athlete, but obviously cross country, like I said, it prepares the athletes for 800s as well as the 1500 meters. So they use this very well. Northwest Athletics Northwest has got Queen Pinar, as well as Kinyadi Itswe Ntsubane is in the mix in that one. Central Gauteng Athletics, you can always look out for them. Jene Kotsia, that's one of the names that I would be looking out for specifically in that one. So don't forget about her. Kanyisile Taldo is also in there. Tembi Mteto is in here. Maki Lisenyo. CGA and AGN, obviously, usually very strong provinces. But KZN is also represented. Home ground advantage. They will also be prepared for this one. We've got Mbali. We've also got Tandiwe Shabangu, as well as Samuke Liswe CBC. And then Western Province Athletics, we've got Tamika Usta, as well as Nadine Fisser to look out for. These are very good athletes.
Temba, thank you very much for that introduction. Clearly, you know more about the long distance scene. The long distance scene is more your scene. So, with this being more your scene, you could give more information to the people back home. And thank you for that. If this was track and field, I would be able to also give, you know, a brief history on the people. You know, it's like, you know, Timber's flexing on his knowledge. Yeah, I'll get it. Anyway, so we, like I said, represented by ten teams. I do believe that this is the Limpopo. This is Limpopo, and they have their spot. Like, I will show you now that there's barely no wind at all here today. You saw the flags over there. You see the teams relaxing in their spots, probably do some of their warm-ups over there. You see the girls also getting ready. more or less 5 minutes before the start of this junior women's race. So this is great.
Right, the girls 5 minutes left now, and the tension is building. I can feel it from where I'm sitting, and I can see it in the girls' faces and body language that they feel it too. Very interesting and hot 6 kilometer race coming soon in around about 4 minutes now.
Ladies, you'll be running 3 laps here this morning on this course here. Thank you, the National Lotteries Commission, for their sponsorship, and to Puma. Thanks, guys. Very, very grateful to you, to Clark Kinlock and his team there, guys. Thank you very much for all the entries and the results and all the problems associated with that. But they've done us proud. So, Clyde and his team, guys, thank you. Very, very grateful to you guys. And to all our officials, guys, thank you very, very much sharing your time now with us and making things go according to the rules. And a lot of protocols with the COVID. So thanks to everybody, our marshals. And of course, to two of the most hardest working people here in Turkey over the last few days in the pouring rain on Thursday. Rian and Luella, guys, thank you very, very much for all your hard work and your dedication. The hardest working team in here in the whole of Turkey. Well done, Rian and Luella, guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
This world can hurt you, it loves you deep and leaves us.
I am back as we get near the start of the junior woman cross country race. They will be competing in six kilometers will be their distance. Please, I would just like to remind you guys at home that you can watch this this feed that we have on Athletic South Africa webpage. You can watch it on YouTube, on Back Sports and Backtrack pages, as well as the ASA pages. So I heard that the whistle for the start of the girls, the junior girls, and they will be competing in the 6 kilometers. We are underway, ladies and gentlemen, with the start of the junior girls. They will be running 6 kilometers. That will be 3 laps of the track. Conditions a little bit cooler here for the girls, as we see them making their way down. We can see that I can hear their spikes going. We can see that this is also, as I mentioned yesterday, the future of South Africa. This is where you start differentiating those that will want to become professional athletes or professional cross-country runners. This is where we start to see that category. 10 provinces represented over here. 10 provinces represented over here. And like Temba said, we do know who our leaders are going to be, because this is his area, this is his field, and he has a whole lot more knowledge of this. With this said, they are going, this is more or less 500 meters. Don't forget to tune on to the pages I told you. Catch all the action on the Athletic South Africa webpage.
Uh-huh.
As well as the Back Sports or Backtrack
ASA YouTube.
There we go.
And yeah, you can just keep on following throughout the weekend. Like I said, I'm excited about this one. Women junior, the 6 kilometer. As you can see, the officials just waiting patiently for the athletes to come into shot again. The officials, as I was speaking to them earlier, it was cold day yesterday. Some of them didn't even bring jackets, but today, yeah, it's a better day, you know. A long day as well, Kurt, ahead of us. But like I said, the juniors, we've got the likes of Jenny Kutia to look out for, as well as Kirsty Bell. Those are very strong athletes. Don't forget about Zanel Sihotle, very strong athlete there as well. Kutse Jene from Central Gauteng Athletics, one of those to look out for. And then we've got the likes of Tandiwe Shabangu from KZN Athletics, as well as Gabriella Gatesmith, Kirsty Bell, as I mentioned, as well as Linka Sneyman. So it's going to be a good one. Definitely looking forward to see how it's going to pan out in this race. It's going to be a fast one, Kurt. I'm telling you, after this one, we've got the juniors coming up, and the junior boys. So that one is also going to be a great race. But as I said, I always look at the under-20 race. That usually sets the mark for what type of athletes or will have at a senior level in the next year or two or three, because these guys end up being the ones who take over the reins from the likes of Dominic Scott to the likes of Mokoka, Nzazi, the Adam Lipschitz of this world, Kurt Kuto.
Oh, the captain of the Social Runners Club. He always tells me that he's the captain of the Social Runners Club. He owns KZN. Funny guy. But yes, these junior men are here to take over that mantle from those great names that you said. And then thank you Temba for providing me with some info. I have the names here that you mentioned, Linka Sneyman, Gabriella Gatesmith, Zanele Siotle. You mentioned that she's might be the sister of Olavio. So
she definitely is the sister of Olavio.
So she's one to watch. I see she's running for, yes, Mpumalanga, that's the hometown. Also Jenei Kutia you mentioned, as well as Tandiwe Shabangu. So I have the names over here, I have the bib numbers over here. I managed to get a better start list today than what I had yesterday. So we will have all the action for you. I will be I will be bringing you all the action from when they go up the course to make their way around the whiteboards.
Yeah, you know this hill, Kurt. We talk about it a lot. This is where a lot of the dissecting of pace happens. And for those who just joined in, welcome to you. This is the girls under 19 race currently taking place in the 4K. They're going to come into picture, as you can see over there. Gabriella Gatesmith, as I mentioned, she's currently in the lead. Excuse the bit of transmission. There's a lot of trees and scenery back there that interferes with the wireless connection at times. But we're bringing you the action, and the Jenny Gutsa is also in there as well, as
you
I mentioned.
You are so right on the names, Demba.
I've seen these girls on the track, Kurt. They're very dominant runners, and they usually run very well. Just apologies, this very wind is picking up again as it did yesterday. But we're going to be back to the transmission there from number one as it comes on slowly. But currently, as you saw, Janae Kutsa is in the mix, as well as the athlete from, if I'm not mistaken, it is Mpumalanga. They were also in the mix. She goes by the name of, it's from Athletic Central Northwest. Her name is Petru Stephanie. She's also in the mix in the front of that one. So we're going to bring that slight disruption. But here's the shot of the next athletes as they're coming through over there. You can see them running through the hill, and they'll go around the track now. And currently in the lead, as I said, is Gabriella Gatesmith. She's got a partner from Athletics Gauteng North as well there. And then Jenny Kutsia is also in there. So those are your leaders. Stephanie sitting in fourth place currently. It is the 6 kilometer. So they'll be taking three laps around here. The time currently 6 minutes flat. And it's going to be a very interesting one to watch. Look out for the latter part of the stage of this race, Kurt. I think that's where the pace is going to start to be getting cranked up.
Yeah, this, you know, when this pace starts to go, Madima, it's like you say, you know these girls so well. You see them running on the track. You, like I say, you flex on me because you know these long distance runners. Like I said yesterday, you guys are like overachievers. You never stop. It's like you have the track season, you have this cross country season, and then you're gonna go into a road season, and then you're gonna go back to a track season, or indoor, and then a track season again. So your knowledge is vast. Your knowledge is on point. And like you said, the girls from AGN, CGA, Athletic Central Northwest, they are the ones in the lead. Like you said yesterday, they play, you know, they have the advantage. They come here, their lungs are filled with oxygen when they come down to sea level. But nonetheless, conditions are the same for all the girls. The wind is picking up. I might have to go and get my jacket. But as these girls are coming in to finish the first loop, to finish this, they're coming in to finish their first lap. Yes, their first lap. 2 kilometers down. They're going for three loops. They are running 6 kilometers. So I'm sure they will have tactics somewhere. They will have tactics somewhere. So they have gone down a little bit, and we will be bringing you the leaders now from CGA. Like Madima, like Temba told me, keep my eyes open for Janae Kutsia. These girls are running. These girls will also definitely beat me. 6 kilometers is way too far for me. With these girls running, we can see that the ones are concluding their first lap. They're concluding their first lap, coming in to make their way down, so that they can go to the lush part of the jungle, where they have the tricky part of the track of this course. And this is quite a challenging course, and the wind is picking up, and it is quite difficult when we know we have the wind over here. But nevertheless, these girls are here to compete. Conditions are the same for everyone as they go. So let's keep our eyes open. Let's keep our eyes open for these girls. We can see a whole lot of them coming in middle group towards the end. From the view that we have, this is more or less the, I wouldn't say halfway, or might be just past halfway point. So they are going. We see girls, yes, the home favorites, KZN, coming in, athlete 23 from KZN, Nolwazi Mabena, coming in there. They are not giving up, they are running. Three laps, this is a 6 kilometer course, I repeat, this is a 6 kilometer course. They are making their way down to the lush jungle of this track. So we keep our eyes open for these girls. Temba, they are running.
Absolutely. As you can see, currently they are going down into the wilderness, as we call it, the bushes. It gets quite hectic down there. We'll be bringing some more footage from you over there, so you can see. But at the moment, as I said, there's a few blind spots on this track because it's such a vast area that is being covered on the track. So we can't get bikes into certain places as well, so we've opted for the safe way to make sure that you can catch up with as much of the action as possible. And you know, if you've been watching, I hope you've been able to follow as much as possible and enjoy that ASA has made an effort to just bring Cross back to us. Hashtag bring Cross back, and Cross is back. Definitely it's important that we don't let go of it or lose the tradition of athletes qualifying to run at cross-country championships. You know, it takes 1 year to break a routine, and 1 year can be too costly. And we're back. The teams are smaller. COVID protocol is being observed at all times, just to make sure that everybody stays safe and healthy during this time. I mean, COVID is real, Kurt. Have you encountered or had an affair with COVID, or have you been safe from it since it started?
No, Temba, I've been safe. As we see there, the leader, she is the leader.
That's Jenny Kutsia from CGA.
I had a name, Temba.
Yeah, she's currently just pushing the pace as she works up the hill. She actually looks back, and guess who is behind her? It's Gabriela Gatesmith. Gabriela's a pit bull herself. You know, she doesn't let go. Once she snatches on your heels, she does tend to lock her jaws. But Jenny Kutsia is the one that is currently pushing the pace. This is a phenomenal runner, Kurt. You can look out for her in the future. Great runner.
Thank you for the heads up. You know, your knowledge in this amazes me. As I was about to say Jenny Kutsia, you jumped to the mic and you say Jenny Kutsia as I started over there. But thank you for saving me. And she is followed by Gabriela Gatesmith, like you said. You see, I'm starting to get the names here. And then after that, it's in third place, Karabo Motseneng from also AGN. So those are the top three at the moment. And going back to what Temba was saying, I didn't have an encounter with COVID. I was very lucky to be vaccinated quite early as part of the Olympic squad preparing for Tokyo 2021 or Tokyo 2020. So I'm lucky, I've stayed safe, I adhered to all the protocols, so I can say thank God that I haven't had an encounter with COVID. But speaking of COVID and the pandemic, I'm just glad that these girls can compete. And while they compete, we saw there that the leader went down the hill, and we bring you back to the middle of the pack where they are making their way up the hill. They make their way up the hill, up a very steep hill, like I said, around the whiteboard. When they go around the whiteboard, they go down a very, very steep downhill, as you can see over there. That the athlete from CJ will be making your way down after that whiteboard. She will be making your way down a steep hill where she'll go to the wet part of the track and making your way to finish the second loop and onto her last lap for this race. I believe you are still led by, I forgot the name. Temba would have killed me, by Janae Kutsia. I guess she will be battling it out with Gabriella Gatesmith and Karabo Motseneng. So I believe those are the athletes that are leading this 6 kilometer race. And we have we bring you the action from this as the girls. I do not think they are about to finish unless I counted wrong. Yes, I did not count wrong. They will still loop for their final lap, I believe they will loop for the final lap. As you could see, it is Janae Kutsia from Central Gauteng Athletics CGA in the lead. She has opened quite the gap, and she is followed by the girls from AGN, Gabriella Gatesmith over there in second place. But now we can see the clear leaders, Janae Kutsia followed by Gabriella Gatesmith, and then in that third spot we are going to have I believe Karabo Motseneng. This is the lead pack. They are separated from one another and they have opened quite a distance from the rest of the pack, I say. And then we can see that perhaps we will see these girls. They might be able to lap their counterparts. So let's see. And yeah, also in the top positions, 1-2-3-3 from CGA, and that is Kenaluane Kumile. So she's going over there, followed by 199 Athletics Central Northwest, Stephanie Petro. So these girls are running. This is definitely the lead pack, but I do believe that no one is going to challenge Janae Kutsia, Gabriella Gatesmith, or Karabo Motseneng. Those two have separated themselves from the group, and they are well ahead.
That is the women's 6 kilometer. We're just covering as they're coming through for their last lap. Some of the girls are coming through for their last lap now. You can see the water points over there, the water points where they're just sorting out to keep the athletes hydrated. Kirsty Bell in picture over there. She's also running in the colors of AGN, as well as other provinces that are represented well. Athletics in Mpumalanga. Athletics Northwest, Transkei in the building. Transkei also have an athlete in this one. She goes by the name of Vuyi Swamofi. She's in here as well, but the person who is currently dominating proceedings goes by the name of Janae Kutsia.
Guys, I tried to throw Temba off by pointing to Gabriella Gatesmith, and he did not fall for it. He knows his game. He knows exactly what is happening in this game.
And it's going to be a tough one, but it looks like Janae has done the decisive moves to make sure that she will win this one. She's currently in the lead, but anything can happen, especially at the back there with that hill that is also approaching. Anything can still happen over there.
That hill, that final hill is quite the challenge, Temba. But like I said, it's really, 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 really tough. It is not easy at all. They make their way down. Some of these girls are coming in for their final lap, and then we might see the leaders coming in not so soon. But we have our cameras ready to capture the girls coming up the hill. And I do believe it will be led by Janae Kutsia. I didn't even look at my notes for that one. Temba will be proud of me. He will be so proud of me. as we wait for these girls to come, we'll just give you feed of the back of the pack coming in. These girls have their own goals, but here we have, is it Gabriela Gatesmith, Temba? No, it's not. It is Janae Kutsia. She is well in the lead. She's just looking back. She's looking back to see how far she is in the lead, but she's well in the lead. Her being in the lead, I believe she will be followed by Gabriela Gatesmith, followed by Karabo Moteneng. Those were the three clear leaders. She is really running outstanding over here. This is really good. Congratulations here. She's running so well. Unless something really Gatesmith. Gabriela Gatesmith will be closely followed. Well, not closely, she's opened the gap, but I do see here that we have Gabriela Gatesmith in the second place, and the gap is big. We do have quite the gap. Checking a watch to see her time. She's probably trying to beat her time from the second lap here onto the last lap, so we keep our eyes open. These girls are contesting this thing fiercely. You can see going down the hill. As some of the girls are making their way for the final lap, I believe that we are getting ready to witness Janae Kutsia coming in for her win. It is not far. Once she makes her way down and up that hill, she has more or less 600 meters to go. And with that 600 meters to go, I will say time 21:45. I do believe that she will be coming in shortly. The back of the pack is also coming, is going to conclude the last lap, and up the hill we have the girls coming away. But we've also been announced that Janae Kutsia is coming in for the win. Janae Kutsia is coming in for the win all by herself. There is Janae Kutsia coming in all by herself, sprinting to the line. She is the victor of the junior woman 6 kilometer race, followed by, I believe it will be Gabriela Gatesmith, and then I will try and give you a number for the young lady that will be coming in third place. So as we keep our eyes on the screen here, we see Gabriela. Janae could see her looking for Gabriela, how far Gabriela is, and we wait for Gabriela as she comes in. Gabriela from AGN, I see on shot her president Hendrik Mokgangetsi over there, but Gabriela Gatesmith in second place, and we will see who will come in third place. Will it be CGA? Will it be AGN? We shall see. Those are the provinces in contention for the third spot. Gabriela Gatesmith seems to be happy over there. Congratulations to her. And we will see who will be coming in for the third place. We keep our eyes glued. Could that be third place? 490. Third place, 490. Karabo Motseneng in third place. Close by athlete 1233 from CGA. 1233 Kenna Leone Kumile from CGA, followed by 1591 is Tamika Uester from Western Province Athletics, and then completing the lead there, 199 Stephanie Petro from Athletic Central North West. So don't forget, you can watch the action here today on the Athletic South Africa webpage. Also, you can watch it on YouTube on Athletics, on the Athletic South Africa YouTube page. Don't miss the action. It is a warm day. Wind is there. So let's not forget that the sun is shining. Even though there's some wind now, the sun is shining. The wind comes and goes, and it's much, much better weather than yesterday. As we welcome the ladies that are finishing, we can see here on our shot 6691 from Athletics in Mpumalanga, Michelle Parks, my Luca also from AGN. As the girls come in, have ones that are coming in on the last stretch of the course. They make their way up the uphill onto a relatively flat piece of ground, and from there hill, and then that will bring us to the finish line. We see the CGA 1235 followed by 16188 Leonore Luber from Athletic Central Northwest. Those are girls that are here from the finish. And as these girls are finishing, I'll just point you out that some are helping out here to clean the course, ready for the junior men. I do believe 3-9-3-6-3 and B. And you can see the girls that are finished, they go, they grab the Coca-Colas, and number 41, also a home favorite, Mbali Msibi, Athletics, finishing 6-7 to these girls. 6-7-9 represented by Rahasebo Mashilo. And we have teams. Yeah, so I really do hope that these days play. These all at play. Number 1013 there from Athletics Transkei, the only girl from Athletics coming in to finish is not easy. We see some of the I see some of the junior men warming up. I see some of the junior men warming up. So the girls are coming in, and some are about to finish. Let's point we are
Nolo.
Ready, I heard are getting ready to start. They are going to be doing 8 kilometers. 8 kilometers takes us to 8 kilometers takes us to 4 laps of this course. This is also a very, very big category. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 13 and 14 provinces represented in the junior men. Junior men are about to start. The guys that are going to be taking over, the likes of Stephen Mukoka, the likes of Precious does some cross country himself. And here we go, we have the start of the junior men, as the junior men are starting. You can see they're starting at a pace to gain some position. This is really, 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 really important as we see them coming in, jostling for position. We have here the runners jostling. They're coming by so quickly. 1-1-0-6 currently in the lead, and that is the Jason Bowers from Athletics Vol Triangle. But this race is going to be one hell of a race. The boys make their way down there. You can see they are bunched up. Going down the downhill, jostling for position. This is very, very important so that you do not lose ground. So they do know the course. They do know what is what's coming up the way. They know what to expect. And as they go down there, they're going to the lush jungle of the of this course. Then they will eventually make their way onto the onto this uphill. The uphill, like I always say, takes us up the hill, down a slight hill. It's quite, and then very, very high, steep hill, where they do then get a flat part of the race, where they then go around the white boards. They go downhill, and as they go downhill, they make their way onto the tricky part of the race. The tricky part of the race is where it's wet, and then they will start their loop. They will be running 8 kilometers, and with eight kilometers they will loop four times. So it will be three times. The wind is picking up and our cameras are sensitive and we can't see what is happening, but we do have some feed now to to give you while we try and get that camera back up and running, because that's an important part of the track, of the course.
That's true, Kurt. Like I said, the weather here has been just jittery the whole weekend. It stabilized much better today compared to yesterday. We've had less challenges. But as you can see, we're just trying to get that going and trying to get it moving back. But the connection seems to be still a problem. But let's sort out camera two and then we can get that action back on.
And as we've sorted out our camera, so we will be able to give you feed from when the junior men come up over here. As we come up over here, they will loop four times. They will loop four times, so we must be ready for the action. But the judges, you can see, they are relaxed. They are ready to show these young men the right position. And as I say that, we have a view of the junior men coming up the hill, still Bowers coming up the hill, followed by number 96. I do believe number 96 is home crowd favorite from KwaZulu-Natal, Sibelo Khumalo. So Sibelo Khumalo and Bowers there in the lead. These two look strong. They unwind their legs down this downhill before they make their way up the very, very, very steep uphill. As we see this happening, we saw a shot of them going up. That's the steep hill that I was speaking about. But we can see they are bunched up. They are bunched up, and we will see the group come up, and then they will make their way past the white board, and we'll see our leaders. They'll go past the white board. Our leaders will go past the white board, and then they'll run a little bit and make their way down onto the wet part of the track. It's quite rugged on towards the end, so that they can conclude their first loop. Time 4:50. 4:50. Let me add that each loop is 2 kilometers. Each loop is 2 kilometers, and with these 2 kilometer loops, they will be running 4 loops. We can see, I think that will be the young man at the end of the pack, or the guys towards the end of the pack, also making their way past the whiteboard. And as we see them, we are going to go to the camera that will take us to the winners, or the leaders rather, before they finish one loop. So we can see it is the home favorite, Sibelo Khumalo, followed by the Vaal athlete Jason Bowers, grabbing both of them, grabbing water over there. It is,
as you can see, Jason Bowers currently in the lead at the moment. There is the young man boxing the pace. He's a phenomenal runner. Obviously, for those of you who are watching, he went to the world junior championships running the 3000 meter there, but he's got company. This one is going to be a ferocious one. You can see these guys are in it to win it. And CGA well represented again, but the athletes from KZN also in there, CAGN represented, Limpopo. It's going to be a good day. ATRA also in the house, EPA, Western Province, Mpumalanga, the works. It's a full house, and it's good to see the athletes, you know, are pushing out. The juniors, Kurt, I always say, this age group determines what type of future we have, and in the likes of Jason Bowers and the other youngsters that are coming up, I definitely think we are in good hands. These guys do not hold back. They're brave. You know, when we interviewed Jason before they headed to World Junior Championships in Kenya, Nairobi, he was saying his aim was to break the SA record at altitude. in Kenya. Altitude in Kenya is tough. Yeah, yeah. But the man is, he set out his goals. He didn't achieve it, but I mean, that's the type of speech, the type of thoughts, the type of confidence you want to hear from our young athletes.
Temba, you're 100% right. And now I remember the face. That's where we saw him when we went to say goodbye to the juniors that went over for the under 20 World Junior Championships in Nairobi, held by the World Athletics. And yes, Jason was very confident. Camera shy. Maybe you will be a little bit better if you can get an interview with him. But nonetheless, like you say, this is going to be ferocious because the home favorite there, Sibelo Khumalo, is hot on his heels. Actually, they are shoulder to shoulder. They are not letting anyone go by. They are shoulder to shoulder. And I would actually like to see, as we approach the halfway point in this race, where they are going to be. If someone is going to make a move, if someone is not going to make a move, if they're going to wait a little bit so that one makes a move before the other. But these juniors are here to take over the future. And when I say future, that will be taking over the likes of Stephen Mukoka and taking over the likes of Precious. And I don't know, I will ask Temba, but Temba, does Precious do cross country or only specializing in 5k 5000?
Precious Mashele is the king of cross country. For those of you who know, I mean, he's usually dominated the national championships in the 10 kilometer for many years. So he's not here now, obviously, because of a longer season going to the Olympic Games and so on. I don't even know if he's here. Maybe he is. We'll check on the team sheet later. But Precious is one of the kings of the 10-kilometer cross-country. Otherwise, years where he was just winning 10Ks on the road, 10K cross-country, back-to-back, every single competition. So he was the undisputed until he got dethroned once by Stephen Mukoka. He got his revenge on the 21K as well this year. So obviously, Mashele, one of those beasts of athletes that are taking over. Yeah, yeah. But as we look into the back shot now, we should be awaiting, anticipating Jason Bowers. And he is there with the man from KZN.
Sibelo
Khumalo. He goes by the name of Sibonelo Khumalo.
Sibonelo.
Sibonelo. A very strong athlete, and this is home ground advantage. I'm sure his family is watching the stream. The people from KZN will be on their feet right now, cheering him on as he continues to pursue that title. He is currently in top two position, so anything can happen at this point. We don't know how fit Jason is. We don't know how fit Bonello is. All we know is that there's still a long way to go in this race, and it's nowhere near finished, Kurt.
It's nowhere near finished, Temba. I mean, these guys are going. I don't know if there could be a slight move by Jason, but these boys are running. They're gonna go for each other. I mean, they are past half. They will be soon at halfway, because as they go past that that whiteboard and they loop again, they will be halfway. They will be at the 4 kilometer mark. Then they will have two more loops to go. And I'm looking forward to this battle between Sibonelo Khumalo and Jason Bowers. Clearly, Jason Bowers is very, very fit. Maybe carrying that fitness or not breaking any training at all from when he went to the World Juniors at in Kenya, Nairobi. And I do not know. This is 8 kilometers. He's a 3,000 meter runner. 3,000 meter steeplechase. Is it steeplechase or just 3,000? 3,000. So let's see how he does here in this 8 kilometer cross country route.
Yeah, I think he's gonna do well. The main important thing is that the 3,000 meter race ends at junior level. So going to senior, it's either he's gonna have to look into the 5,000 or he's gonna have to look at the 3,000 steeplechase, which I don't think is well suited for him and his type of running. So he'll definitely either have to decide between a phenomenal 1,500. Or the 5,000. I think he'll be more well suited for the 5,000 in the future. But who am I to say? I'm just a humble servant and an observer of the sport. So we'll see which way he goes. But I mean, all I know is that Kurt, this guy is super talented. He's focused. He trains with his training partner, Renier de Villiers. Very good training partner. Obviously, Renier breaking the 1:46 mark this year. So if you're training with somebody who's running a 1:45, Kurt, it means you got some speed in your legs.
That's right. You got some
but
speed.
He's also got the tank. So I don't think the 8K will be a problem for him. I believe he can take this title. It's just a matter of how much that Sibonelo wanted the boy from Kumalo, KZN bred.
As we could see over there, he was coming in, and he has made a bit of a move. I believe he has made a bit of a move. We will see him on shot over here, and Sibonelo now a little bit behind. So we see Jason has taken a commanding lead. He has taken a commanding lead. So let's keep our eyes peeled. As we can see the runners, the top two are well on their way. Yeah, we have the battle for third place between CGA and Val as well. 1157 will be the teammate of Jason Bowers, goes by the name of Temba Tingane. 1157. He's followed by CGA, so that's the battle for third place. But still a lot to run. They're only halfway. So this is their third loop before they come for their final loop. These boys are doing really, really well. So we're going to keep our eyes open for them as they're coming over here. We see the middle and the back of the group coming in. 8 kilometers is quite far, but they are really fit, and they are doing phenomenally well. Like Temba said, mentioned earlier, all the provinces are here. Transkei, Athletics Northwest, North, Central, Northwest, Mpumalanga, AGN, the home favorites, KZN, CGA, Transkei, Limpopo, they are all here. The junior men category is being contested by 62 juniors. It's quite a big race, this, and they're all here. We have the action for you here. We see them taking water. It is hot. It is not. The wind blows. The wind doesn't blow. It is quite tricky. So we are here to bring you the action as we see these guys coming in and going to end the loop at the toughest, one of the toughest part of the track. Some of these boys really, really brave, running barefoot. So I don't know how they do it, but I guess they are used to it. They are competing, they are doing well. Some are in spikes, some are not. Some have the actual cross-country shoe. So this is really, really, really exciting. I see that we do not have any shoe saga here for the cross-country, like the road running or the track. But we see that these boys, some are running in spikes, some are running in sneakers, and others are running barefoot. And they are way past halfway. Time on the clock, 15 minutes 26. And as we go to camera one, I want just to show you guys that the leaders will be coming up this uphill. And from this uphill, we will then see if Jason has made a move, if Sibonelo has closed the gap. This is exciting. The leaders are doing are way ahead. So let's keep our eyes open. But for now, we will go to the guys at the bottom of the pack as they make their way to the thick, lush jungle of this Amanzimtoti course. And we go back to the leaders. Still the leader is Jason Bowers. I wonder if his gap has grown, but he's coming up the hill, followed in second place by Sibonelo Kumalo, and Jason has made a gap. He is way in the lead. Jason is in the lead, followed by Sibonelo Kumalo from KZN. So this will be a medal today for the home crowd. I'm sure as he goes past somewhere, he will be cheered on by his fans. So we see Jason unwinding his legs, taking the advantage of that little bit of a downhill before he makes his way up the uphill. And then we will also see now Sibonelo also unwinding his with this. We can see they make their way up. So as we see these guys Vol triangle, but clearly Jason is still on the lead. Temba,
he currently looks strong. I said it, this boy is a very phenomenal talent. Comfortable, but you can see he's well chased by Sibonelo Pumalo from KZN in the KZN colors. He's pushing on.
And if you can see, I do believe it will be Jason Bauer's teammate from Athletics, Vol Triangle 1156. Hey, you have a friend there, Temba. He's in third place.
Currently in third place. I think he's got a good distance from the rest of the pack, so he's going to be looking to try to hold. We're going to see hold on to that position as we go into the final.
Is going from Athletics Vol Triangle, and then we also see here more athletes contesting for the top spots. This is the top order. These guys are the top Athletics Gauteng North, Central Gauteng Athletics, Athletics Gauteng North. These boys are running, and then we'll go back to see some of the middle now coming through, grabbing water, staying hydrated. While that is happening, we do see then the guys at the back of the pack busy going down the hill to make their way up the very steep hill. So they might get lapped by Jason, we will see, but like you say, there are top spots to up for grabs. There's team spots up for grabs, and they are also personal bests or personal achievements. But as we can see, it's full of action in this very big junior category of 62 junior men. Very, very big, Temba. But nonetheless, the leaders have separated themselves. They're running for the top. Really, 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 really important. The athletes 10-5-2 is from Athletics Transkei. Sinovuyo Sikanga, Athletics Transkei being represented well. And then we'll take a shot there to Athletics Vol Triangle, where they will be making their way to the lush jungle of the track, where they run close to the river. It's tricky, it's rocky, it's thick, where they will then make their way up the uphill. As we see Jason coming in, this is Jason coming in for the win. He's got quite the lead, Jason Bowers, the athlete from Athletics Vol Triangle. And in second place to the finish, this is frantic, this is action. These boys are coming in. You can see that Temba from Athletics Vol Triangle is closing the gap on Sibonelo Kumalo. Let us see if this will be the way. We will then switch our cameras to the finish line, so that we can get to see Jason coming in, so that we can see that top three spot coming in. While we go to the finish line, we can see some of the runners making their way down the hill, up, so that they go behind the board. Here is Central Gauteng Athletics, and with that we see that the guys are going to soon be ready to bring the tape out. And while they're getting underway for Jason to cross the line, some of the runners are making their way to the finish. I believe from where we see that runner there is more or less 600 meters to the finish line. And we are going to get ready to witness Jason Bowers coming in. He was the clear leader. Jason Bowers was the clear leader. So let us see to see if it will be Jason Bowers from Athletics Vol Triangle that is going to win this junior men. And it is Jason Bowers, the winner of the junior men 8 kilometers, with the time of unofficial here for us, maybe 25:15. So well done to Jason. And in second place, I believe we're going to get Sibonelo, or maybe it will be the teammate Temba of Athletics Vol Triangle. And it is the teammate of Jason Bowers from Athletics Vol Triangle, followed in third place by Siboneno from KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, and we heard a big cheer from the crowd as they witnessed these junior men coming in. And what a race did we have from these top three gentlemen. We will keep our eyes, and then fourth place was Athletics Gauteng North by 576. Did I get it right? 576, but it is Athletics Gauteng North. I cannot see this number, maybe can't get ours. 502, then 502 is on the top spot, and I cannot get the name on my well detailed list, but 62 contestants sent also filling in the top spots. Like I say, I do believe there are individual goals up for grabs, but also there are team goals here at play. The guys are coming in. Just before that, I just want to have a word with Temba. Temba, what do you make of the performance of Jason Bowers, and then the Vault Triangle grabbing the 1 and 2 with his teammate from Athletics Vault Triangle, Temba Tingani, getting the silver?
I think it's very good running from Jason. He's showing a lot of maturity. I did say he's one of the favorites to win that race, and he did not disappoint. I mean, I think, you know, especially what you see very often is that when guys go to major championships such as World Junior Championships or whatever it is, they just come back with a different mentality. And I think it's, you've got a taste of running against the best in the world. So by the time you come back home, you've got this urgency and this hunger to say, you know what, if I can run against the best in the world, I don't want to lose to anybody in South Africa. And that tends to happen to most of these athletes. But the thing is that he's pulling his teammate along with, and this guy's got a powerful name. I mean, Temba, come on, Curtis, that's a very powerful name. It means hope, and Temba was actually in third place, and because of his hope, he finished in second. So definitely a very strong running, impressive running for him to do that. And that's what we want to see. The crowd went crazy when it happened. They were excited. That's the type of excitement with Anthony Timotius. So it's going to be exciting, the 4-kilometer races to come for the seniors under 23s as well. And then there's some masters races that you can always look out for. The masters race in the 4-kilometer is always very interesting. So Kurt, it's a good day. That race, I think, has raised the excitement in the stadium.
We have a lot of action here, Temba. We have a lot, like I say, a lot of action. We heard the crowd cheering, which was really, 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 really lovely. We see the guys coming in. We see that it's amazing how the crowd cheered. Like you said, hope. Temba means hope. Temba contested for that silver medal place along with the athlete from Athletics Vault Triangle. Oh, sorry. Yes, Temba got the medal. Hope he got the silver. Beat Kumalo, I believe, on the line for the bronze.
For that the bronze is medal. True.
And as we see these guys coming in thick and fast, I do believe here underway. We will take. From junior men, I beg your pardon, we are going to be now seeing the action from the senior woman, and the senior woman are going to be doing the 10 kilometers. Temba knows more or less what's on, and he will be joining me. So the senior woman will be doing 10 kilometers, five loops of the track. as I do believe some of the junior men are still coming in, I'm just bringing you shots of the woman warming up, as well as the final group of the men's getting ready to finish. Not so long after this contested hill, I do believe that they have more Eastern Province Athletics. This is the lineup of senior 86 runner track will be run by these phenomenal and strong women. They will be going there, and then they will be making their way up to this hill, where they'll go a little bit flat, and then eventually they will make their way. It will be like there on the track, but these women are there to steep hill. So we are open for these girls as they are making their way up. She's going down. She will be going down the hill, where we will then catch her as she will be finishing her first loop. And with this, we see the other runners coming in. The senior woman, well contested, coming up here. Very, 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 very tough course. You can see this by runner 1454, Limpopo Athletics, Janet Mahota. So we are gonna get ready so that we can catch the lead group coming in to finish their loop. They come around that second whiteboard. I believe that it's really, 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 really wet over there as they are coming in, and we just have to keep our eyes open for the senior woman group coming in. The finish, I believe, is the toughest part. And we can see here that the lead is still held by Caleb Jacobs from Western Province Athletics. But very, very strong contest there by Janet Mbele of KwaZulu-Natal Athletics. Also in the lead group, 332. I believe those are the top spots. 332 goes by the name of Kesa Oletsane. So, and she is from Athletics Free State. The ladies grabbing their water as they make their way to the first loop, so that they can finish the first loop. And I will show you as they will be coming in. The lead group hasn't changed much, but I do see now that there is a Central Gauteng Athletics in the mix by number 1300, Farida Zwane. So this is going to be a good group. Also for number 485, Stella Marais from Athletics Gauteng North in the lead group. This is very, very, very well contested, contested group. As we see some of the girls coming in as well. This is the middle group, as more runners of the middle group make their way out to that lush piece of terrain of the jungle of the Amanzimtoti course. We see here runners coming in, grabbing their waters, runners making their way to finish the loop, runners everywhere. 5 laps, we're going to see a whole lot of action. I will make sure we see all the action from the leaders, the action from the middle pack, the action from the end pack, as these ladies are running. This course is grueling. It's not forgiving, as you can see on the facial expression of some of these girls. Some of these girls as they are coming in. and going to the lush piece of jungle. So we see these girls over here. As I'm here commentating, they make their way past the lush jungle of this Amazon Toti track. Weather is better, wind is picking up, but the sun is shining. And let me see if I can get a wave. I do see Qwen over here. Qwen, can I get a wave? Qwen does wave at me. But yes, Qwen voting for the Social Runners Club. I haven't seen the captain of the Social Runners Club, Adam Lipschitz, yet, but we can see that the athletes are coming in, and they will be coming in past their second loop, and they will be making their way up here. I'm just waiting to make sure these girls are coming in. You can see that the weather's good. They are coming in. The people are there. The referees are checking everything. We are trying to grab all the action. Wind picked up a little bit, but not much. And we just need to keep our eyes open. We can see those judges over there, they are really, really relaxed, but they are orientating these women as they make their way to their second loop. We had a runner come in over there. They will be making their way up this uphill for their second loop. It is not easy, but it is quite something. I walked this loop myself, and I must say this part for me was one of the toughest. As we can see, we see the lead group coming in now. The lead group over here is now led by the Free State Athletics, Free State athlete number 332, Kesa Molotsani, as well as shoulder to shoulder with 1590, Kayla Jacobs of Western Province Athletics. The home favorite still there in the mix, number 28, Janet Mbele, as well as the athlete from CGA 1300, Farida Zwane. She is in the mix. So this is going to be a very, very close senior woman finish, I believe, unless they're saving it and they are ready to make a move at a later stage. We see them coming there up the hill. Now they've made their way up the hill. This is where they will make their way to the behind the whiteboard, to the very steep downhill. We have some close-up action there for you, and then we will see them running where they will go behind the whiteboard onto the downhill. And as they go onto the downhill, we see that this is really, really well contested. And while they are busy disputing for the lead, I will bring you also the lead pack, which will be leading for the top places. Like I say, this is usually not only about the top places, but also the team places are up for grabs over here, and also just about the participation. Participation is really, 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 really important over here. And then we do get some girls as well still making the way up the second part of the track. So we are ready for these girls to come and complete their second loop. You can see we will shortly be ready to witness the girls coming in for their second loop, as the girls on the middle and the back of the pack are disputing for position. So we will bring action of these girls, because those top five girls, I think we are gonna get ready for a very, very, very exciting finish with those 5 goals. I do believe there are, they should be coming here, they should be coming here shortly, and they are indeed coming here. This is still led by Western Province Athletics, followed by Free State Athletics, as well as KwaZulu-Natal Athletics and Central Gauteng Athletics. These top four women are in the mix. The home favorite has taken an early lead. Temba, can you give us some feedback over there? What do you think?
Oh, it's a very good race. I mean, if you look at the lineup in this race, you can see the athletes coming now on the front there. You've got the likes of Kesa Moletsane. You've got the likes of Kesa Moletsane. And don't forget the lady from KZN. She's a very phenomenal runner. She goes by the name of Janet Mbele. We've seen her on the road. We've seen her in many recent competition. Kesa Moletsane, obviously. Ainsley, also in there. Ainsley, formerly known as Ainsley Van Gran. But that's Ainsley. No, sorry. I'm mistaking her for, I'm confusing her with her sister, but it is Ainsley, definitely. There you can see Stella Marais in the colors of AGN, as well as Farida in CGA colors. So it's a good 10 kilometer. I think Kesa's gonna try to push this one hard, but Janet Mbele from KZN, she's running at home ground, so she's gonna be looking to dominate the proceedings. I'm sure she's been on this track a few times and knows it very well as well. So let's see how this one will pan out, Kurt, because it is a very good run. It's still early though, so anything can still happen at this point. But the athletes that I would definitely look out for is Kayla Jacobs. That is the sister of Ainsley. I kind of confused them a bit, but it's Kayla Jacobs running in the colors of Western Province, with Janet Mbele running in the colors of KZN. And then don't forget about Kesa Molotsane, she's in there as well, running for Athletics Free State. And then Beauty Maloba, also from Athletics Gauteng North. So it's a beautiful race. It's going to be a good one. Let's see how it pans out as we get into the later stages of this competition, Kurt.
Temba, it is quite a beautiful race, but very interesting over here. The senior women are spacing themselves out quite far apart from one another. So we have the lead group, which is those top five women, and then there's a lot of gaps coming in. So definitely the action will be coming in from the girls in the top group, because they are very, very separated from one another. And I'm here to bring you all the action. Also, we will be seeing some of the athletes coming in, making their way for the third loop. These girls are running 10 kilometers. Yes, KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, followed by Athletics Gauteng North. So the action is coming. We are seeing them running, and while that is going on, we are going to go to the uphill, where we see the athlete by the number 1454 from Limpopo Athletics, Janet Mahota, coming in. She's definitely part of the back group, and then we will see how these girls will be going down to that lush piece of jungle. But like I said earlier on, majority or the big groups in this competition are Athletics Gauteng North, Central Gauteng Athletics, KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, even though the top positions are only 1-1-1 currently held by Western Province Athletics, KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, if I'm not mistaken, Athletics Free State. So we have a lot of action from the top group, and my eyes are glued on the screen so that I can be able to give you guys some action of these women coming in. Currently unofficial time of 18 minutes 50, and as some of these girls make their way around, you can see wind picking up slowly, but this group is definitely the group from behind. And we'll go now to the leaders, where it's still there. Free State Athletics Free State by Kesa Molotsane, followed by KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, as well as Western Province Athletics, as well as a new runner in the mix, 1287 Sasile Sosibo from Central Gauteng Athletics. That means that when when we had runner 1300 Farida Zwane, she might have dropped off the pack, but these are our top four women athletics Free State, Gauteng North Athletics, Western Province Athletics, and Athletics KwaZulu-Natal Athletics. This is our top four women contesting for that lead. This is their third loop, so please keep your eyes on this feed. We will bring you the action. As you see the girls coming up at the last uphill, then they will make their way onto that backdrop, and we'll see now a front shot of this front group. And this is five loops of this track, as the lead group is going around there before they make their way down. We see now the middle of the group. He has runner 1402 Eastern Province Athletics, the only representative, Nwabisa Majoli. She is running her heart out. We see here Central Gauteng Athletics, followed by Athletics Gauteng North. These two ladies are definitely competing for the team competition. And as we try to get the action to see these girls coming in for their final loop, I will bring you to that little bit of steep hill where we have here Beauty Maloba coming in as she made her way past the thick lush jungle. The senior women are running 10 kilometers. That's five loops of the track. And as they're doing this, I do believe that the senior men will be warming up as they take center stage next. And we see here 520 from Beatrice Temani from Athletics Gauteng North. With that, we will see the lead group of girls coming in for their loop. So let's keep our eyes open for those top four girls that were in the lead. Yet again, they're staying together. This is Western Province Athletics, Central Gauteng Athletics, Athletics Gauteng North, and KwaZulu-Natal Athletics. Kayla Jacobs, 3-3-2 is Athletics Gauteng North. Keisa Moletsane, she's there, number 28. Janet Mbele from KwaZulu-Natal Athletics. And then we have 1287 Sasile Sosibo from Central Gauteng Athletics. As they make their way to our camera, you will get a feed of them coming in the lead. These girls are running on their penultimate lap, so this is a lot of action. The lead is being contested fiercely by these top four women. No move has been made yet, and as we see here, some of the athletes making their way onto the uphill. Some of the athletes will be making their way to finish the loop. All the action is coming up. I do believe we will get some athletes getting lapped over here, so I'm really, really hoping our cameramen stay with the lead group over here. We see Athletics Gauteng North, represented by Stella Marais. She's going for her fourth lap, so we will keep our eyes open for that. We have some of the back group girls making their way at the bottom to make their way up. From where they are more or less now, I do believe it's about 800 meters before they cross the loop. We see the girls grabbing their water, running, completing their loops, plenty of water to go around. The volunteers are making sure the route is staying free of the plastic. They are making sure all is in order. Yes, athlete from Athletics Gauteng North grabbing some water, and we get another shot of her as we get to see her running, and where she will make her way all the way down. As you can see that athlete running, she will go down into the lush, lush jungle. And with that, we go to some of the girls on the back of the pack, where they will be coming to complete their third lap. If I believe, I see here as they are doing this, I see here Ezekiel Sipeng, a legend in the athletics in South Africa. I will try and get the legend Ezekiel Sipeng to come and speak to the public, just so that he can have his opinion over here on how the cross country is going. But he's all smiles and he is really, really happy with how the organization is going. So I will speak to Ezekiel and see if he has time to speak to us, and I will get back to you guys. Until then, we continue with the senior woman, 10 kilometer, 5 loops. This is way more than what I would do. Way, way, way more than what I would do. So as we see the girls coming in, this is a tough, tough course. Uphill, down the course, over there. We have to keep our eyes glued on the leaders, as well as the middle pack. A lot of action happening. But we have the judges here. You can see they are ready to welcome the lead group when they do come here. We see some runners over there making their way to complete the loop. This 2 kilometer loop is quite big, as we see these girls coming in from where I am over here. I do believe that they are already way past halfway. As we see here, we have a runner from Athletics Gauteng North coming into our screen. Number 508 is being represented by Marilise Ritz, Athletics Gauteng North. This is a grueling course. It is not an easy course, and the conditions are a whole lot better. And here we have number 1000 is being represented by, I cannot get this number, number 1000, but I did see it is part, I do believe, of Western District. But here we go to feed. Here's the lead. Now there's only three. We have Western Province Athletics, we have KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, and we have Athletics Free State. For once since I have been commentating, we can see that the lead is not being held by Athletics Gauteng North or by Central Gauteng Athletics, but Central Gauteng Athletics is still in the top four place with this said, we could see that they have gone, they are now over there where they will make their way past the white, past the whiteboard, past the whiteboard, down the downhill. So we have all the action of this lead group here for you, as the lead group is over there. I do see that we might have a lady that is done. She's walking on the opposite side of the course. I think this course is a bit too much for our athlete 663. Our athlete 6663 is from Athletics Mpumalanga, Tandeka. I think Tandeka has had enough of this course, and that is her getting some water from one of the officials. This was a grueling course. We see some of the runners coming up as they are coming up. We see them making their way onto the flat before they go down and again onto the uphill. And we have some, and then you see there Tandeka really, really struggling. So it's really, 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 really difficult at the moment. So we will also shift our cameras to see if we can catch the woman coming in, the lead. So I also just got a note over here as we see these girls coming in. I do believe they will get lapped by the lead group. I just got a message from Social Runners Club captain. I'm hoping to try and get him in over here so that he will commentate a bit with me for the men's 10 kilometer race. But yeah, we see here the women are coming in. The lead, this is the lead pack that we have here, and the lead is now held by number 28 KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, Janet Mbele. She's the lead. Second place Athletics Free State, and that is runner Ketsa Moletsane, followed by Kayla Jacobs from Western Province. So these girls are battling it out fiercely. As you can see, they're coming. They are shoulder to shoulder. This is their last lap, I do believe. So keep your eyes open for this lead group. In fourth place, you will see coming in is athlete number 1287 from Central Gauteng Athletics. 1287, Sasili Sosibo. She's in fourth place. Maybe she can upset the lead group. We will see how that goes. While they are disputing and going into the jungle, we are going to be welcoming some girls into finishing the loop. As you can see over there, this is part of the loop that they will be running, and I'll take you to better front view feed where they grab their water and they continue running. You see now here Athletics Gauteng North, I do believe number 485, let's say it's Stella Marais, Athletics Gauteng North. She's definitely in the top 10, like I said, not only the top places, but also the team places are up for grabs. We see there Stella Marais getting a drink of her water before she makes her way. And we see another athlete from Eastern Province coming in. And then I will take you to feed where we will see girls coming in before they also do. That the athletes are coming in. These athletes that we have on shot now are going to finish their loop, going for their final loop. So all eyes peeled on these ladies. This is the 10 kilometer senior woman contested by 26 contestants we've had so far for the whole day. Only one casualty. And as we see this girl coming in for the jungle part of the track, as I like to call it, we see some others coming in, as well as others from the bottom of the group that I believe will be lapped, coming for the flat part before they complete their loop. As we see here, we go to Athletics Gauteng North. 484 is Beauty Maloba. She's there. She is definitely in the top 20 places, as there are only 26 runners. I'll still give her maybe top 15, as she is running really, really, really well. I can't get a number 1,000. I do not have an entry here for number 1,000. I do not have this runner's name, but from the gear, I do believe it could be Athletics South Western District. So the ladies will be making their way over there, where you see there could be a medic running over there. If I can see clearly, that is a medic. The medic is going to the aid of an athlete. Like I said, the medics have been really, really, really outstanding. So we could have had two casualties today. So far, we do know that it's only one casualty, and that is the athlete from Athletics Mpumalanga, Tandeka Satsayo. I do apologize for my pronunciation. I am from Mozambique. I am not familiar with the South African dialects. So as we are here, we see the girls are coming up the hill, and they are hurting. This is not easy. This is not easy at all. not easy at all. As you see, we see the lead group now here. They are coming for the finish. This is the lead group coming from the finish. Now in the lead is Skaler Jacobs from Western Province, closely followed by Athletics Free State Kesa Molotsane. And then Kesa Molotsane is number 28 for the bronze. Over there it is Janet Mbele, but she is also she's going to get challenged very closely by the athlete from Central Gauteng Athletics that goes by the name of Sasile Sosibo there. I don't know. Oh, now 12-10 Makoma Bachi. Maybe Sasile Sosibo fell, I do not know, but those are the top places, those are the top four places. And we are going to get ready to welcome these women. So we have to get ready to welcome these women. As you can see, they'll make their way past the backdrop, where they will then go down the hill and make their way to the finish on the toughest part of the track. We see here the athletes coming in as we get our cameras ready to take the finish line. We are going to be ready to see the finish line. So we are going to start welcoming these ladies. These are the ladies that are coming in, so we have to keep our eyes open.
No. Finish line. Oh, just give me a minute and we'll leave finish line. Get the finish line.
Madima, the finish.
Yes, thanks. The leaders are coming in, I believe.
Don't you want to dump it on that computer?
This is not
communication. Oh, it was internet. I thought I was live. I am live. So just testing my mic. I had a bit of a noise, but I can see now that we are getting ready to see the winners coming in. So we have to see who is going to come in for the win. The winners are coming in, and I do believe it is Athletics Free State. Kesa Molotsane taking the lead, followed by Kayla Jacobs from Western Province in second place. And third place is going to go to the home favorite. I actually had my money on Janet Mbele. I thought she was going to make a kick. And the bronze goes to KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, Janet Mbele. Those are our top three finishers. As we get some more shots of, like I said, the girls are really, really well spaced out. But as we get some more shots of the woman coming in, you can see that this race was really, really just contested by these three women. We had a very, very strong finish over there. We see the finish now of the other woman coming in. Top five will go to Central Gauteng Athletics with bib number 1287. That is was one of my favorites. I thought she was going to make a move. Sasile Sosibo, like I said, the race won just over 35 minutes, so we have to keep our eye open as we see more and more women coming in. I said there was a casualty. There is the medics helping number 520. That is Beatrice Temane from Athletics Gauteng North. She is being held by helped by the officials while some are still getting ready to finish this race. As we see this athlete coming in, she is coming in to finish a loop. So we are covering not only the winners but also those that are running with heart and to finish. There's another finish for Athletics Gauteng North, 1300 Farida Zwane. She's definitely in the top 10, finishing the race in about 39:20 unofficial time. So we have a lot of action over here. Medics being really, really, really helpful over here. They came to the aid of the senior woman from Athletics Gauteng North, Beatrice Temane.
Marais finishing here. Oh, it's going to be 40 minutes for you, Stella. Well done. Gauteng Athletics Gauteng North. Batobile Mkeza from KwaZulu Natal finishing here as well. Just over 40 minutes or so.
We see this Stella Marais coming in, definitely top 10 athletics, Gauteng North. Temba, while you were away, I got a message from the captain of the Social Runners Club, and I'm hoping to try and pull him in to commentate with me over here. What do you think? He knows the senior men.
Yeah, senior men's race coming up shortly, Kurt. The guys are already warming up and getting ready for this one. We're just waiting for the rest of the ladies to just finish up before we get into those, and then we'll touch on the men. It is going to be a humdinger. That's what they call it, a humdinger of a race. You can expect some phenomenal times. Let's just run you through all of the athletes that will be running. We've got Joel Mone from Athletics Central Gauteng. We've got Puseletso Mufokeng from Athletics Central Gauteng. Thabang Musiako, look out for this man, he is a dangerous. Tumelo Mutahale, very dangerous athlete as well, also from Athletics Central Gauteng. Athletics Central Northwest, sorry, these are athletes from Central Northwest. I see Mutahale has moved. We've got Ian Slinger, also from Athletics Northwest. And a whole lot of other athletes from the Northwest. A very strong team. They've got Tuko Loho Buikanyo, as well as Athletics Free State is well represented by Victor Mbese. Mbesele, he's also from Athletics Gauteng. And then it's a big field. This is a very big field, so I don't think I'll be able to get through all the names, but let's see how far we can get before they kick off. The ladies' race is still continuing, the women's 10-kilometer race. As you can see, they're still coming up at the back there. It's 42 minutes into the race, 42 minutes and some change. So that's the women's 10-kilometer race. Obviously, that one was won by a fantastic athlete. She goes by the name of Kesa Molotsane. We know her very well. Her reputation precedes her. She's done it all, and she continues to keep shining. And keeps hungry whilst giving back to the sport as well, you know. And then she was obviously followed by Taylor Jacobs, the sister of Ainsley, Van Gran Van Gran. So that's how that race panned out. So next up, we do have the men's race that is coming up. As you can see, the men are lining up and getting ready for this one. They are standing in their positions right now. As you can see, the winds are blowing, so the winds have picked up again. So that is something that they will have to deal with and face. But let's get back to the athletes. We've got the likes of Njokum Zoluzi from Athletics Free State. Pakiso Mtembu, this youngster, look out for him, also from Athletics Free State. Tsepo Nyapotse from Athletics Free State. We've got from Athletics Gauteng North, look out for this man. Milton Kikana, we've got Khadi McCollins, Regan Magwai from AGN. Masemola Kamuhelo from AGN. Simon Mukonyane from Athletics Gauteng North, as well as Rantsu Mokopane. Look out for those ones. And then we've got Mpumalanga, we've got Lepoto Tsiamo, Moses Mahlangu, Freedom Makubela, as well as Matima Lebohang from Athletics Mpumalanga. Katlego Moloi and Nkabinde Mandla, also from Athletics Gauteng, Athletics Mpumalanga, apologies. And then we've got Michael Dube from Athletics Northwest North. Khabe Tswe, Godfrey, also from Athletics Northwest. Tatokikana, Oaheng, Khopisi, Matthews Lieto, Khomotso Musiawe, as well, those athletes all from Athletics Northwest. And then from Athletics Southern Western District, we've got the likes of Bernardo Fredericks, Donovan Yankees Maqhosa. Francois, he's in there. I think it's Maqhosa. And then we've got Apiwe. Ngweniso is in there from Athletics Southwestern District. And then we've got the likes of Apiwe and Mervin Stinkham, also from ASWD. And then Athletics Transkei is represented by three athletes, Vuyoletu, Nsebenzo, as well as Awetu Ntsoto. They are in the mix representing the province for Athletics Transkei. And then Vow Triangle is represented by Mukwena Edward, as well as Tabiso Mosekeli Puletato, as well as Tari Modupi. Those are the athletes from AVT. And then Border Athletics is represented by Apelele Fanako. We've got Yanga Malusi as well as Zugisa Wanga from Border Athletics. And then Central Gauteng, this is probably one of the stronger provinces when it comes to the 10 kilometer. They've got the likes of Kabelo Milamu, look out for him. Lucky Mohale, also we want to look out for Samuel Muloi. Nicholas Sioposengwe, this youngster, very strong athlete as well. Andres Sesedi, Elvis Tau as well from Central Gauteng Athletics. And then you can look out for Isao Meriano, France Melukaya, as well as Tolisa Mzumbini from Eastern Province Athletics, aka EPA. And then we've got some more athletes, a big field, as I said, a total of 70 athletes running in this one. That's Busiso Kubeka from KZN. I've got Mbuleli Matanga, look out for this man, phenomenal runner. He's also lined up. We've also got Makwande Mkwenjengi. He's gonna be running KZN for KZN, as well as Sine Temba Mchangase from KZN. And then we've got Mkedisani Opungula from KZN, as well as Bongi Nkosi Zwane from KZN. And then let's bring it up to the penultimate province, Limpopo Athletics. We've got Silo Homo, we've got Muleli Malisela Yangi, and we've also got Noah Mutimiri, as well as Polusho Palati. And then we've got Puti Chitoa, as well as Zino Tsipa, Tsipa Highway from Limpopo Athletics as well. And then that is also followed up by the ultimate, the final province is WPA, as it saved the best for last. I don't know if it's just the order it was in, but Western Province, they've got Merlin Cluster, they've got Keaton a lot, Sbusiso Madigizela, Ashley Blocky, Funny Plain Smith, as well as Thomas Struis. And that wraps up what is going to be a fantastic race in the men's at 10 kilometers. Coming up soon, guys, you can expect a humdinger of a race. It's going to be so exciting, it's going to be fast, and I'm sure you're going to enjoy it. So let's just wait and see. Who do you have your money on? I've got my favorites, but it's not about me, it's about who's going to produce the results.
Demba, I didn't tell you, but I managed to get the captain of the Social Runners Club. He is the main man here in KZN. He calls himself. He's also apparently the main man at the Mshlanga Runners Club. This man has it all, you know. So we are here ready for the men's 10,000 meter. Look, I'm a track athlete. It's the 10 kilometer. I'm a track athlete. I thought it was 10,000 meter. But ladies and gentlemen, let me welcome you to the captain of the Social Runners Club worldwide here in KZN. Adam Lipschitz.
Good morning, everyone. Glad that you can join us here for the men's 10th kilometer cross country. And Kurt, who do we have here today?
We are about to start with the men. We are about to start with the men 10 kilometer. I'll bring you an update on the start list now that you can have a quick view on the live stream so that you can know who exactly is running.
Thanks a lot, Curtis Jackson. Thanks for having us. Adam Lipschitz in the building, the leader, the captain of the Social Runners Club. He's with us. We've got a phenomenal 10K coming up, Adam. The likes of Mbuleli Matanga, obviously, from KZN. He's one of those to look out for. But then there's a lot of guys. Kabelo Milamu, you can look out for him. The boy is in phenomenal shape as well. Ashley Brocky Smith, Funny Plain. He's also in here. WPA is well represented, so it's gonna be a humdinger. I don't know who's gonna take it, but all I know is that I'm super excited for this one. And your thoughts, please.
Yeah, I saw Ransel warming up there, Ransel Mokopane, from formerly from Potchefstroom but now out of Pretoria. Am I correct on that?
That is correct.
He's a former 4 kilometer champion, I think, cross country. I think he's won it multiple times, so he's definitely a favorite to look at. And Mbuleli, obviously, the hometown favorite, Matanga. Running for Pantane, but in KZN colors today. We don't know his shape. We haven't seen him running lately. Haven't actually seen any of these guys running lately in the last couple of months. So it's actually an open race, I think. I don't think we have a favorite.
It's going to be a tough one. Kabelo, from what has been in phenomenal shape. But like I said, this is nationals now. It's a matter of who's going to show up to the party. Regan Maguire also in the colors of AGN in there. We usually see him in the 4K. Let's see how he looks. But you can see the Western Province Army is ready. The men from Val Triangle are ready. It's going to be a good one, Adam. Run us through the tradition of the 10K. There was a very big while where Precious Mashele was dominating back after back-to-back titles. And look at the youngster. As you can see him there in front, Paki Somtembu. He's a good runner as well. He looks like he's in shape. If he's in front, he's up to something.
Yeah, and I saw Lucky Mohale up in the front there. He's a front runner. Don't be surprised to see him take the lead. We don't know his shape either, but he loves to run. And again, it's an open race, so anyone's race.
Yeah.
And yeah, they've just come past us. They've just started about 400 meters into the race. I don't think anyone's going to take the lead yet, but Matanga does like to run from the front. He does like to go out and hurt the guys and not let you get comfortable.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we've seen him run with Precious Mashele. So there's a bit of blind spots in this race for those of you who are watching online. It's very difficult to get motorbikes in some of those areas. So what we've done is we've put cameras strategically in places where it is safe enough to put cameras. But as we were saying, there's a lot of guys. We don't know what shape they're in. COVID has played a big part in what happens. But we'll just give you some of the action of some of the places that you need to look out for. The hill that we are showing here, this is where a lot of the decisive moves take place. We're running the senior men 10 kilometer. The women's race just finished, and we had Kesa Molotsane winning that one, followed by Kayla Jacobs. And the men's race, as we said, it's open. Let's see what type of form the guys will have. So if you're looking at cross-country training, Adam, how important is this when it comes to preparation for the rest of the season?
So cross country is by far the most difficult distance between everything, between track, road, whatever you want to run. Cross country is where everyone meets. So this race might be won by a 1500 meter runner, and a 10,000 specialist might not perform. So it varies, you know, Temba. It's very open, and this really shows you who the strongest people in the country are.
Absolutely.
Stephen McCork obviously dominated cross country for long periods of time, and he basically is the front runner in the country.
Yeah, absolutely. As you can see from the danger tape there, the wind is picking up here. Much better than yesterday. Compared to yesterday, we'll take these conditions any day. Next year is a big year when it comes to track and field, when it comes to cross country, when it comes to Commonwealth Games. There's just so many major competitions that are coming up, and it's going to be interesting to see how the athletes dissect their season in order to prepare for that. You know, the crazy thing about distance running is, Kurt was saying it, there's no stopping. Like, after track season,
straight into cross country.
After cross country,
straight into the road.
After road,
back to track.
Come on, man, it doesn't stop.
It does not stop. You keep running, and that's why we love the sport.
Absolutely. Looking at the back there, we still have one of the ladies that is running in the colors of, I'm not sure, Limpopo. It looks like Limpopo colors. Yeah, she's coming through for a finish. It's important to finish. It's a tough course, as we said, very grueling, a lot of turns. We'll bring the gentlemen to you soon. They should be coming through soon around the corner. Now then you can have a look at those ones. Then we'll see, as you can see, they are starting to appear into the shot. We'll get it soon when the cameraman focuses. I think he's still just on the ladies from Limpopo. But as you can see here, is the man from KZN number 115. In the colors of KZN, he goes by the name of Makwande Mkwanga. He's the man currently in the lead. Home ground advantage, and Lucky Mohale,
as I said, will be near the front.
Exactly. And then there's another man from KZN, Mbuleli Matanga. It looks like he's speaking to the rest of the KZN army. They're up to something. It looks like they're just fighting to make sure that the pace is fast. Pakisom Tembo is still in there. Very early stages. They're going to be approaching almost, let's call it 800, 700 meter at that point, coming to the first K.
I think they just passed they passed the kilometer. They're about a K and a half in.
Yes, it's 1.7.
And you definitely want to look out for Mbuleli. You know, this is, he's run this course. He won the KZN Cross Country Champs not too long ago, I think 3 weeks ago, on the same course. He ran 30 minutes and 35 seconds, if I'm correct. So he definitely knows the course. It's a very flat one. It's a bit off-road down along the river, what you're seeing now in picture. And then it's basically on fields. So it's fast, it's flat. You don't have time to rest uphill or downhill, and you just got to keep going. So look out for Mbuleli. I'm sure he's going to close that gap and put his fartlek, his famous fartlek.
Yeah, Mbuleli is very dangerous. I mean, we've seen him go head-to-head with Precious Mashele on numerous occasions. And you said they've ran the course before, so that home ground advantage rests real at this stage. Just a bit of connection challenges at the moment with, I said, the wind is just picking up tremendously at the moment. But we're just going to be fighting to try and get as much action to you as they come through for what is going to be their first 2 kilometer lap. We'll give you that action shortly.
Yeah, and as in picture, we're seeing the back markers come through. The gap looks about 200 meters or so. So
stretching out these guards out to
Alright, and here they come, as you can see, coming for the first lap, as the likes of Ashley Blocky Smith is in the mix there as well. The guys just grabbing some water, getting some refreshment, and as you can see, the leader is still the man from KZN. He's still out there in the front at the moment. He's the man to chase. I think he's playing a chase, catch me if you can. And you can see Mbuleli Matanga currently in second place.
Yeah, so in the group, you've got Lucky Mohale trying to close the gap. I saw Thabang Mosiako from Potchefstroom, very strong runner. Yes. 101 half marathon runner, 28 minute 10k runner, 13 minute 5k runner. So he's definitely also one to look out for.
Absolutely.
I saw Ashley Blocky Smith also coming through at the back there in the group. So yeah, it looks like a fartlek just been thrown not too long ago by Mbuleli and opened the race up quite a bit. But yeah, we're looking for a good race coming up now.
Absolutely. And it's still early, as you can see, the guys are still just navigating their way through the course. It's still just 7 minutes and 22 seconds into the race. So it's gonna start cranking up soon as we get into the the important phase of the race. It's only 2Ks and already there's some choke slams and some gauntlets and some fartleks have been thrown in there. So they're gonna be cooking up a crazy meal shortly.
Yeah, so headed down to the river again, passing the 2.5 kilometer mark. We haven't got visuals yet of who's in the lead, but I suspect Mbuleli has taken the lead. They're gonna come up again past us very shortly, so we can update you on that. But yeah, very fast, very... Kurt, what would you say the weather's today? Very cold or...?
No, yesterday, Adam, yesterday I was freezing. I'm sure I sent you messages telling you to come over here and you're in your jacuzzi in Schlanger. But okay, I'll leave that to you. You know, it's like I was actually a little bit jealous of you and Temba, because you guys have the knowledge of this. You guys know the guys. It's quite amazing. You guys don't even need the start list, man.
Not needed of the start list, Kurt, because we know the good runners in this country. They've been around for a long time. And they've been dominating for a long time. A good bunch of runners have moved away from the rest. So, yeah, everyone knows who they are.
With that said, I believe you're a bit biased here. The good runners are not only the long distance runners, Temba. Sorry, Adam, or should I call you Captain? So, if I say something, it's like the guys on the track. I know the guys on the track. But besides that, you can see, like you said, good weather. Yes, it's a little bit windy, it's not too cold, but people are in sunglasses today and not in a whole lot of beanies. And I mean, they're in good mood. The crowd is actually, I don't know how previous championships were, but the crowd is quite good here today.
Yeah, so obviously following COVID protocols, Athletic South Africa have not let spectators come in, which is a bit of a shame. Cross country is normally very well attended. You're looking at 4,500 to 5,000 entries, and I believe there's only 1,600 entries this year. So only 30% of participants are here, based on the age groups that were left out and the lack of parents and spectators that normally make the trip down to wherever it is. So it's a bit disappointing, but I'm sure they'll still put on a good show in the 10-kilometer men's race.
I believe so as well. Now you mentioned some age groups were left out yesterday in day one. Today, ladies and gentlemen, this is day two of the SA Cross Country Championships 2021 here in Mazantoti, KZN. But when you say left out yesterday we had I see the winners are coming up over there, Adam.
Yeah, so that's Mbuleli. As predicted, he's taken the lead. Ooh. He's not waiting for anyone. It looks like he is with one other runner. I don't know his name at the moment. I can find that out. But they've opened a gap of about 30 to 40 meters, about 10 seconds. So very comfortable for him in the moment. And I believe that gap will just open as the race goes on.
So going back to age groups, yesterday in day one we had 8, under 8 all the way to under 13, under 8, under 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. But please do check on who is that runner that is with the leader over there, please, Adam. But like I was saying, you and Temba have this great insight of the athletes. You guys don't even need the start list for this men 10-kilometer race. And do you think that was a move by the, did you say Mbuleni Matanga, was that a move by Matanga not to wait?
He's known to not want to wait around for too long. He enjoys running from the front and leading, especially in a race like this. So yeah, it looks like he's made his move very early on, only about 3.5 kilometers into the race, and we'll see how it plays out. We don't have the best coverage due to the course position, but we'll keep you up to date as it goes.
I agree. I totally agree with you. So we will try and get the runners coming in for the loop, as well as bringing in them in so that they can finish the loop. So we will take camera to the leaders over here, Adam, that you can see 899. I think he is, I'll check for you, and I'll get you the name, Adam.
Check the name of the second runner, because I'm a bit lost. But Mbuleli is leading, and He's opening the gap. He's coming past us. He's opened the gap about 10 meters. Oh, it's looking hot, but he's looking comfortable. The second runner, 8.99, we will find his name now. And coming in the chasing pack, there's Bongankosi Zwane, Sibusiso Kubeka, and Thabang Mosiako.
Adam, if I must be honest with you, I cannot find... Sorry, I was looking at the... list, probably why you also couldn't get, but 899 is Matthews Leto from Athletics Northwest North.
Yeah, so following the chasing group, you have Regan from Athletics Gauteng North and Franz Melikaya down from Port Elizabeth. He's a very strong runner and he's been in fine shape the last couple weeks, running 28 minutes along the Summer Strand streets down in Port Elizabeth. So a good race. Let's see if they can maybe close that gap a bit. We're still not past the halfway mark, so we've got a long way to go and a good race still to come.
We say a long way to go, but Adam, what do you think is a predicted time? I don't know if you know this course. I don't know if you walked it. I walked it yesterday, so I can't really tell you much about it, but what are your thoughts on the course and the time that we might be heavier for this win today?
Yeah, so they've passed the 4 kilometer mark. I think they did go just under 12 minutes, if it is that where I think it is. So we're looking at a sub 30 or just over 30 minutes, which in this weather and on this course is very good, because Kurt, from our view, we see fields, very flat fields, but I've run this course a few times, and as you go down to the river, it gets very tricky. The sand is very soft. It's one single path, lanes. We don't have visuals of that, but you do slow down a bit, and there are some very sharp, steep uphills along the course.
Thank you, Adam. As you said that, what I was busy telling the people back home and the people watching, that when they go down over here, they go down into the actual jungle part of this Amazon Toti course, because I walked it to try and get the cameras best placed for this, and it's really, really tough, Adam. As soon as you go down there, like you said, thick sand, thick grass, stony, they're running close to a river. So if you've run it, I still think I could take you on this course over 1 kilometer, Adam.
Going back to the race, Mbuleli is still leading. He will be coming up along the riverbank again onto the field and back round the field to finish his third lap in the next couple minutes. I believe he's got a substantial lead, Kurt, and I don't see anyone catching him. The group behind him looked like they were working together, but I think he's comfortable out in the front.
Yeah, Adam, the way I saw him come past us here when we had this feed, it was quite something. I mean, he's moving, he's pulling away, he's not slowing down, and I do not know what else to say, but I think he hasn't even made his move, so he's going.
Yeah, he's, as I said, I think he's very comfortable. I think he knows what he's doing. He's got a game plan. You know, he is coached by Mdudu Kumalo down in Durban from Pantane. He's produced some very good runners over the last couple of years and has cemented himself as a great coach in this country. So, yeah, they've obviously come in with a game plan. I wouldn't have known Mbuleli's shape coming into this race. I did not see him run any races recently. I do know he was struggling a couple weeks ago, but he's obviously shaken that off and has come here prepared for the race.
So, captain of the social club, are you also part of the Pantane club? As we're going to get some footage of
Mbuleli Matanga
coming in.
And it looks like he's opened that gap to a good 70, 80 meters, 15 seconds or so. So he's pulling away. The second runner looks like he's still safe in second. He's got quite a big gap, about 100 meters to the chasing pack, consisting of a few of the KZN guys, Sibusiso Kubeka and Bongankosi Zwane, and one or two Central Gauteng athletes. But all in all, it looks like it's Mbuleli's race to lose.
It is Mbuleli's race to lose indeed. And like you said, he is the hot favorite. He is the man from KwaZulu-Natal Athletics. He is running in the colors of KwaZulu-Natal Athletics, but he does run for Pantani Club. I believe is the same club that you belong to.
That's correct, Kurt.
So the captain of the Social Runners Club is part of the Pantene Club. Very, very good club. They belong here to KZN, and they have quite the group of long distance runners.
Yeah, and I may say, Kurt, I think I'm a bit surprised that some of the athletes, you know, coming into this race, they did have good shape, but clearly shows that Mbuleli is in better shape.
I agree with you. And I was even speaking with Timo, you know, training at altitude is an advantage when you come down to sea level, but clearly that has not affected the leader.
Yeah, and Mbuleli coming around now for his 6 kilometer, just over 18 minutes, about 3 minutes and 2 seconds a kilometer. Very, very comfortable. That gap seems to be opening with every stride. And yeah, 4Ks to go, and all for Mbuleli.
All for Mbuleli. Although, I mean, the gap is what you say. It's more than 50 meters by now, Adam. I mean, if we have to go and look at the runner from 899, where did I say? Matthews Leto from Athletics Northwest North, the only man really challenging Mbuleli for this win. But I guess we have a good race for the third place. 417, 135, 154. So let's go. 417 is Athletics Free State, Pasiko.
So Matthew Letts has just come past us. He is looking quite tired, and the chasing group coming past us now is looking in good shape. They look very comfortable, consisting of the athlete from CGA, Free State, and KZN, Bonkosi Zwane.
So as I said, these are the guys that are going to dispute the bronze medal, because gold is gone. KZN.
Gold is gone. I don't think silver is gone. I did see, I must mention, Regan coming through the back there. He wasn't anywhere to be seen about a lap or two ago, so he's looking strong. He's coming up into that chasing group in third, and don't be surprised if he can sneak into a medal.
Well, I will definitely take your advice and your word on this, because you know the long distance scene. You know the guys that are coming in, looping here, just keep finishing 6Ks, going for the 8K. You know what it is like to do cross country. It's already way, way, way too far for me, but I do believe that experience plays a role, and definitely you know what's going on, Adam.
Yes, so again, a lot of athletes that had fantastic track seasons, fantastic track season early on this year, who you would suspect coming into this would have great form, you know, off-season form, have that mileage in their legs. But it clearly shows that it's a different game. Cross country is a completely different game. Again, we saw Franz Milikai, he's running in about 15th place or so. He's the top man in form right now in long distance in this country. So for him to be that far down just shows that cross country and the road is two separate events.
100% there once again. This I can agree with you, because I know that indoor running and outdoor running is totally different things. Totally two different things. And I'm so glad you pointed that out to the guys. You did, however, didn't make a mention, because Mbuleni was coming out. Do you think that the guys at altitude have an advantage when they come down to sea level?
So there's definitely an advantage, 100%. It's a few percent advantage. They should be comfortable down here. I really do. But I'm bringing it down to the little hills, these little short uphills that we don't see in sight. They're down there. I'm going to walk down there after this race and have a look to see exactly what they've done. But I think those are putting strain on a lot of these athletes, especially the track athletes.
And the girls, 14 years old, you need to make your way to the top fielder now with the host, and here's the 35 kickers.
But yeah, Adam, you were saying, do you really believe that the little hills are the ones that are making the difference here?
Definitely, Kurt. From our position, we've got a hill, and we see Kieran Walker walking past there, taking photos of the athletes. I'm sure we'll see some very nice ones on Facebook later. But yeah, there's a hill just in front of us. We are about at the 1.5 kilometer mark, where Mbuleli will be coming up very soon. And it is a very, very steep hill.
Thank you. I said this to the guys because I walked the course, and that hill is dangerous. I also do believe that Mbuleni will come and lap the guys, Adam. trust me when I say this, that man is in form, that man is running so well, and in no time we will be getting footage of him going around that whiteboard down into the wet section of this cross-country track. But as you can see, officials are relaxed, waiting to let the guys go in. Some guys that are concluding the loops are coming in. But here's the leader, Adam.
Mbuleli Matanga, number 108 from KwaZulu-Natal, looking very, very comfortable. And that gap continues to open. It is safe to say this race is won with more than just under three kilometers to go, Kurt.
So, Adam, judging by the time of 23:10, what do you think the time will be for
Mbuleli Matanga?
For Mbuleni.
Just a quick update. You see that group has closed on the second runner, Matthews Litu. And Regan from AGN has caught up to that group as predicted. And he is sitting at the back. I do feel he's going to come through and make a move for that second place very soon. But in that group, we've got Bung Nkosi-Zwane, who's having a fantastic race. You know, he's a marathon runner at best. He's a heart-to-heart ultra and marathon runner running in the colors of Pantane. So for him to be up here in a 10K race with a lot of runners that are minutes faster than him is a fantastic run for him. But obviously, hometown advantage, and he's very used to these conditions.
This is something quite astonishing, Adam, because these runners, like you say, marathon is also a total different ball game when it comes to running. So well done, Adam. Now we have camera back, so we will be able to see Mbuleni coming in on that uphill section. So this is the section I'm talking about. Now we have feet over there. We managed to remove some of the bush over there so that we could get some feet there. But here we see him. We see
Mbuleli Matanga coming on for his 8 kilometers and 24:33. So that will be a just under 31-minute 10K. But he is starting to lap the back markers as predicted.
We got a lap. So, yes, I predicted, not you. And I don't know, Temba, are you going to take us home for this last 1 kilometer by Mbuleni with Adam, please?
Yeah, so we welcome back Temba Madiba to my co-commentator for this race. We've got about 2 kilometers left and a fantastic race. You know, it looks like the first place is gone, Temba, but the second place is very much up for grabs. And here they come past us with about a 10-meter gap.
Yep, 10-meter gap. Obviously, like you said, Mbuleli Matanga, he knows this course very well and he's doing phenomenally. The guys are trying to stay there. You can see the likes of Regan Maguire, Thabang Mosiako, as well as Pakiso Mtembu also just trying to work together to keep a decent pace. You know, you don't want to fade too much. Yep. But as you said, at the moment, Mbuleli is running on about a 31-minute pace. I don't think he'll be pushed to try to get it even sub 31. Of course, 30 generally over the past years has been enough to win. It's just a matter of whether it's a low 30 or a higher 30. Actually, there's Thabang Mosiako.
Yeah, so Thabang Mosiako has fallen off that chasing pack. It looks, as I saw, Temba, as you were speaking, it looked like Regan had made a move for that second position to try and catch up. So I've got my money on Regan for that silver medal, which will be a fantastic result. He's had an up and down season. You know more about him than me, Temba.
Yeah, Maguire has been struggling with a lot of injuries. Obviously, training in Pretoria with the likes of Tipi Tipi, Intsimbinga Gobeki, a steel that does not bend, Superman, Stephen Mokoka. I mean, and the thing is that with running, as with any event, it's not something that anybody's immune to. You saw Tipi also had challenges at the World Championships, at the Olympic Games actually. Yeah. And it's just one of those, you know, you can plan and you can prepare and things still don't always go the way you want it to. And that's sport, you know?
Yeah, so there are a lot of runners that are not here today. The likes of Precious Mashele, the in-form middle distance runner, I think he's taking a rest or he's just not ready to run yet.
It's the first time we see Precious not
taking a rest.
Yeah. it is foreign. It is foreign. It is very foreign for him to rest. He's usually one that used to run back to back. But that just shows maturity. You know, as you get more mature and get a bit smarter, you tend to want to space out your energy output a bit more. It's not about wrestling every single fight, you know. Sometimes it's better to lose the battles and win the war.
Yeah, correct. So, unfortunately, no Precious Mashele this year. He is our defending champion from last year, or the year before.
The year before
we were COVID-stricken last year. So that's a shame. I think we would have had a great battle with Mbuleli and Precious once again, but we've been robbed of that. But I'm sure there's more to come, Temba.
Our Precious is quite a pit bull. Like I keep saying, when he decides he's going for it, he goes for it completely. You can see that's a bit of a back action. These are the guys that are quite at the back at the moment, but Mbuleli Matanga should be coming through into your shot shortly. He's the man who's in the lead. But before we get to him, just a look at some of the guys who are working their way. This is the final lap. I mean, it's tough running five laps around a track. Even though at least it's a bigger loop, it's not as easy as it seems.
Yeah, and as you say, that Mbuleli comes around, probably passing around the 9 kilometer mark, as comfortable as can be.
Just having a bit of a connection challenge there. Like I said, the wind is picking up a bit. Too much trees as well in that area, so it just makes it hard. But there is, again, you can see Mbuleli Matanga cruising away,
heading up to that steep little incline, as said.
But for him, it looks like a little snack, the way he just nibbles it up. And then from there on, it's running home to glory. Nobody will stop him at this stage, unless if he trips and he gets eaten by an alligator around the lake when he turns over here.
Mbuleli Matanga in absolute cruise control and heading for his first South African national cross-country title.
Impressive stuff. I mean, every title counts, and to be the national champion, he just looks at his watch to make sure that the pace is fine. He knows he doesn't have to dig any deeper to make this one come home. And you can see the athletes in that other positions are fighting for the minor positions.
Yep, but it looks, and like there you see Regan Maguire in second position.
Yes,
chasing Mbuleli down, but has he left it too late? Bongankosi Zwane in third position. A fantastic run from him as well. And fourth position, Matthews Lietu, who just faded there at the last kilometer or so. He was holding on to that second very well, but it looks like this race is going down to the wire for the second and third position, Temba.
I'm very interested to see what we're going to see on the clock as they come towards the finish line there. The officials just waiting eagerly, even though they're in a shot to welcome the people as they come home. But as you can see, some of the guys still working there, but we'll be bringing the winner, your champion. It is going to be the man who is the inform man, KZN man. KZN, you can stand up. One of your own child is bringing it home.
Mbuleli Matanga, and he will be adding his second national title after he picked up the 10,000 meter track title up in Pretoria in April.
That is correct. They've put out the ribbon, and it's time for the ceremony. It's a come home party. Everybody wants a piece of him. People are fighting to get in the shot. There's photographers, videographers, Kieran Walker. We've also got Pixel Sport. Oh my word.
And a great day for Mdu Kumalo, Mbuleli's coach, bringing home his second national title in a time of 31 minutes flat.
Absolutely.
Well done, Mbuleli Matanga. Fantastic run, and he controlled this race from the beginning. He let them predict the pace for 2 kilometers,
and then he took over. I mean, he does not any further than run about the past 3Ks. And there's Regan Maguire coming through for a silver. The time just a bit over 31 minutes. And the man from KZN,
Bonginkosi Zwane.
Bonginkosi. Doing a bit of a cross there, bonging his Nkosi, which means thank God. That's what his name means. So as you can see, the men in picture there, the top four just coming across the line.
Yeah, and a shame for Matthews Lietu. You know, he held on to that medal position for quite a while and just lost it there in the last kilometer. So unfortunately, he goes home with no medal today, but fantastic run by him.
Yeah, absolutely. It's just one of those, that's the thing with cross country. You know, you think you've got it. You hit one turn or just one heel. This Thabang Mosiako also coming through. Pakisom Tembu, as you can see. Kabelo Milamu, I expected a bit more from him. Also just coming through, but the guys are satisfied with their performance. Just a bit under 32 minutes. The course is tough. I mean, if the guys, these are top runners running 32s, 31s, Adam, for the win.
So a lot of these guys are 29-minute runners at exactly. their best, comfortably on the road. But again, this course is a lot harder than we see. There's a lot of single lane down in the bush where we don't have visuals of. And that's where the problem is.
Yeah, absolutely. But fantastic race, Adam. Thanks for joining us for this one. It's been fantastic getting a bit of that insight from KZN's darling, KZN's...
captain of the Social Runners Club.
Exactly, Mondo. Yeah,
thanks for having me, and I'll see you guys later.
Awesomeness. Thanks a lot.
Cheers, guys.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that was the 10-kilometer men's race. As you saw, we had the man with us here, Adam Lipschitz, bringing a bit of commentary, and it was a good one to have him as a part of us. So we're just going to be moving on to the rest of it now. Just a bit of transmission challenges that are currently happening. But we're just working to bring that back to you at the moment. And as you can see, action from the back there. The winds are picking up, as we said, just making it a bit difficult to get the shots as smooth as usual. But we'll be trying and working hard to make sure that we bring it back to normal as soon as possible.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we go to the girls under 14, we are going to move to the next link. So this first session for the live stream is done, and then we are going to go over to the mid-afternoon session, which will start with the girls 14 years old. The girls 14 years old will only be running 4 kilometers, so that's two loops, followed by the boys 14 years old, followed by the girls 15 years old, followed by the boys 15 years old, girls 16, boys 16, girls 17, boys 17, and then we have the senior women, senior men 4 kilometer, and then the women and the men under 23 to finish the program off for us. And that's a goodbye for session one. Thank you. See you in the next link.